This is Approaching Troy, and you're listening to PPRN Radio.
What's going on? This is Brandon from Vail Maya, and you're listening to PPRN.
What's up? This is Mark from Vail Maya, and you're listening to PPRN.
Okay, early to bed, early to rise makes a woman healthy, wealthy, and wise. That's why you're wiser than me. It's Stephen.
Hi, I'm Maurice. I'm an executive by day and a wild man by night.
Hi, my name's Monroe. You've probably already noticed that I have incredibly blue eyes.
Hi, my name is Phil. Most of my friends call me Big Phil.
Okay, I like to talk to people deep into the night.
I play guitar.
I'm Eitan.
Hi, I'm Fred.
Hi, my name's Mike, and if you're sitting there watching this tape smoking your cigarette, well, hit the fast forward button, because I don't smoke and I don't like people who do smoke.
I'm not afraid to get sand on my tuxedo if you're not afraid to let the wind mess your hair up a little bit when I take the top down.
Perhaps even a nice bath with some champagne and candles.
Hi, Mom.
I do fashion photography, and I do consider myself a refined valley dude.
Okay, I'm looking for a trendy girl with a simple smile. Wait, it says here. Oh, excuse me.
I don't know. What I'm not looking for is some big, overgrown monster that's always thinking about food and...
Whoso binds to himself a joy, doth its winged life destroy.
I like to do a lot of sailing. I like to outdoor activities. I like climbing. I like travel.
I took a sponge ball and was pulling him out of a little girl's ear.
Vivacious, foxy.
I'm looking for the goddess. Are you the goddess? Who is the goddess? The goddess is the woman, is a woman, is any woman, is all women.
A figure that is sexy, slim, tight, excellent legs.
I'm a 25-year subscriber to both Playboy and the New Yorker magazine.
At night, I operate a damsel in distress hotline. I guess you'd call me a knight.
One of my favorite foods is pizza.
And just... sugar and spice and all those things that are nice.
I like to be with people who are as fun and adventuresome as well.
Is into having fun.
Have fun.
I enjoy having fun, yes.
Looking for somebody who likes to have a lot of fun.
I'm looking for someone to have fun with.
Love to have a good time.
Able to have fun.
Fun and laughter.
And anything that's fun. I like to have fun.
And have a lot of fun.
Are you looking for me?
No fatties.
I want it all.
No hamsters.
I steal watches.
No dopers, no smokers, no alcoholics.
We don't like to write checks.
No Donna Juanitas.
We don't like to take out the garbage.
No posers.
What I'm doing right now is making a movie about World War II.
No crazies.
Santa Monica and my front porch swing.
I'm currently involved in cleaning up toxic waste.
I'm not having fun doing this.
Do you like cats?
Domestic violence.
I like to wear bright socks, and I'm an avid Cleveland Browns fan.
Sexual abuse.
Life is a playground and I want somebody to play with.
All sorts of alcoholics and addicts and stuff.
Because I really have a zany sense of humor.
We probably don't like to clean the house.
My mother still writes to me regularly.
Because I average about 4 hours a night sleep.
I will cry at a commercial.
I'm interested in most phases of data processing.
Fire-breathing dragons.
Type A, I'm not. Comfortable, caring, and serious about a relationship, I am.
I'm really looking for somebody I can feel special about, and I don't encounter people like that very often, and I'm hoping...
It's Doobie, White Snatcher, you're listening to PPRN, you fucking wanker. You're listening to PPRN, motherfucker.
Welcome. What you were just listening to was 80s video dating.
Wasn't it sexy?
Yeah, that was 80s. That was the Tinder of our day.
Yeah.
No fatties.
No fatties. I'm not
look very hamster lover.
Why not?
if you're a smoker, fast forward.
Hi, Mom. You see that guy that was waving hi to his mother?
Call. Just call 1-800-EAT-KID.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Bob's mom.
If she's hearing us, we're in trouble. She's in the grave. With a pocket
full of shells. What's up, Al? Weapons are food.
Oh, yeah. I didn't either.
I
was sober for a couple months.
Alcoholic evil. All right, tonight it's format upgrade, which means we're going to go back to being who we used to be without Fireball.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to be able to do what we say we want. We're going to actually concentrate on one guest every week.
It's going to be good.
We're going to have our round table, and then we're going to have our one guest. Well, he's not really a guest.
Well, we got him
not.
Well, he's not a guest either. He's Saturday.
Yeah, I know, but there's still guests.
Other guests, yeah.
They're on the show before you, so he's got to read.
Well, technically, they're
he's got to read.
Huh?
He's got to read.
Yeah,
oh, yeah, he's got to read the squirting book.
Yes. Technically, Mike.
I don't know how to read.
Is that mic not working?
Check one.
Yeah, it's on. It's on. It's like, the music is on. That's why. Jamie comes from radio background. Used to do a morning show.
First time here. That's the initiation.
Yeah, we met via email.
Yeah. Go with it now.
You're welcome.
You're more than welcome.
Oh, come on. You added to the show.
Don't say thank you. We're going to make you come more.
Yeah.
Not only that.
Don't say thank you. We're going to make you come a lot more.
That's really not fair.
Hopefully.
More than Mike does.
Hopefully.
Well,
he's got you on wine, so something's happening tonight.
Hell yeah.
You going to eat any turkey too later? You know what Mike calls what you're doing tonight? He calls it a Cosby.
Yeah.
You're going to fall asleep. You're not going to know when you wake up.
I got the cowgirl boots waiting.
Nice.
She passes out. Those are going on.
Beautiful.
You were her.
They're going to share.
Think about me.
Welcome. It's Tuesday. We are starting off a new week. And, yes, I'm going to start it off with some negativity. There's no more other shows on the network besides Mixtape Saturday and All Things Sports. So we tried. We failed. Fuck it.
No, we didn't
fail. Well, we didn't fail personally.
Other things didn't work out.
So. To being us.
Fuck them.
That's right.
Hey.
Got to pay the rent again by ourselves, Ricky.
We already were.
I know.
Yeah.
Fucking hate, right.
You weren't getting a lot of help.
Fuck the haters.
Fucking.
I don't know, man. Something happens, you know. I'll get on the street and make a couple moves for you.
Yeah?
What talk about, man. That's what you
mill here, mill there.
Fucking move this shit over
there. Mikey.
Move this shit over
there. You don't know what happened?
Who you going to hit?
But you know what's nice? Because you don't even care.
Yeah. Isn't that
like
awesome?
You didn't take
ask.
A side.
We're
that's
like,
awesome.
Yeah,
where the
like
fuck's fucking pedophile?
We have no idea what's going on.
Yeah. He's no longer with us.
You're better
bye
off.
Bye. Peace the fuck
yeah,
out.
Yeah, no. I mean,
hey,
that's
I love everybody.
But honestly, that's your stress, not mine, man. Yeah.
I don't have any more stress. I got her. I got a new water filter because our water was smelling like fucking eggs and ether.
Nice.
Oh, like Florida water.
Yeah.
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 That's terrible.
It was all brown and stuff.
Beautiful.
Like you're moving
the fucking people.
Water sucks down there, man. Holy there's too much
fuck.
Of it. It stinks.
People fucking messaging me while I'm on the air. Don't you know better?
Don't you know better yet?
Fuckers. Charlie's here. Hey, Charlie.
I'm here.
Hey, Charlie.
You know what I'm going to do, too? You think this is tacky? I'm going to have name tags for everybody.
No.
Not at all.
No, not the people I know. She's going to get me labels, and I'm going to write their name on it so I don't forget. Because when I do what we learned a lot, I'm like,
me and Peter both out.
I'm hoping they're looking at me. I'm like, oh, so what'd you learn?
Mike understands.
I think you should do name tags at the front door with a little, like, gift basket.
Yeah.
That way you get it.
What's like, in the basket? Condoms?
No. A name tag. With a marker.
Okay.
When you come in.
Oh, you know, we can have them do color your own badge.
Yeah.
There you go.
Like give them a box of crayons from Outback.
That's
and
very
then color your own badge.
Well, I forget my own studies. Name half the time.
Yeah. Kathleen's like, yeah, that's great.
It's helping people.
Well, coloring's very therapeutic.
Yeah, it helps you.
For adults. Like,
Jamie, you're quiet.
It's a big thing now.
My mother's 85. She does the color.
I saw it on public.
Sucking it all in?
Finding my stride. I don't know when I can get it.
These motherfuckers don't shut up, so you better just jump in when you can.
I forget my own name.
So we had a really nice turnout this weekend again, but nobody realized that Saturday was all repeats, but except for Jamie, one of the hardest working DJs.
God bless.
That's actually my tail.
Somebody else was in Vermont for the weekend. I'm not going to mention any names.
I was.
Oh, you?
Yes.
I missed you.
I don't know.
Nobody sent me tapes this week except for Jamie. Oh, no, Joe Antonio.
It's hard. Hard keeping
no, I know. Listen, I know it's hard for every weekend. You know what I'm doing is I'm building up because on Labor Day, what I want to do is I want to start 7 o'clock in the morning Friday and then Monday night at 10 o'clock and then just fucking. Because we got to keep it going throughout the winter because there's no other radio stations that do mixing in the winter.
Now,
so that'll be our time to shine.
Peter, put an ad in the. During the mixtape, saying any mixtape DJs out there, if you'd like to audition, send me an audition tape. I can get you into the regular rotation.
That wouldn't be fair because Jamie just sent me a tape and I played it.
Well, yeah. It's okay.
Jamie's like,
but
shut
I'm saying,
up, Bob.
Right?
I get my stuff on.
What I'm saying, what are you doing? Build up the stable.
Yeah, we are.
You can get more stuff flowing in.
We are. We got a Manny's got a cousin in New York that's gonna. They're gonna hype us up in the Bronx.
I tried that. My guy failed. So.
Yeah, he didn't fail. He just it wasn't his thing. I think when he got upset was when he found out how many people were listening. So whatever.
How many?
Doesn't matter. One or 1,000 doesn't matter.
Okay.
So.
As long as someone.
Red
listening.
Red Cougar. What's Red Cougar?
Oh, I know John Cougar. Menstrual cramp.
It's hot down here again.
No, it's not that bad.
No, it's not bad.
I still got the fucking usually chills. I'm having the fever over the weekend.
Picks up.
When you pointed that fan, what were you trying to accomplish? Crosswind?
Actually,
I feel great over here.
Yeah, but she's got one fan going this way. And then
no,
the
no. I had it pointed this way a little bit. I don't know what happened.
Okay.
What happened?
Because that's a little ghetto.
I don't know
what happened. I want you to read
Cougar. I don't know
Cougar.
What happened.
Oh, read Cougar. So Jamie's new, so we have to get him to read a paragraph out of squirting.
Yeah.
Do you mind?
Oh, no.
Read a paragraph out of squirting.
Read a paragraph.
You got to read a paragraph, brother.
Oh, he's copping out. Go into the back of the book.
I never got to read.
You didn't read one yet? Oh, you're next. Then.
No.
You didn't read one?
No.
Oh.
You have to.
We got to get you.
I don't know if I want to.
Well, it's a good
you got to.
It's a good one?
Don't matter if you want to. You got to.
Yeah, it is.
Shit. What does it feel like? Female ejaculation is one of the most incredible, pleasurable feelings. Unlike a clitoral orgasm, the pleasure is not centralized, but instead, it extends throughout your body.
Nice.
It's an ultimate release, a deep feeling with lots of warmth and wetness. Your whole body experiences contractions. Am I done? Like I have to
a paragraph. Right?
Okay. Oh, okay. Well, I mean, it keeps going.
That's every orgasm I ever had. Women can only have like a special moment.
I'm going now.
I mean, that describes every orgasm there is for a man.
Total body control.
We took a little ride to the old Pound Town station today.
Pound Town.
Nice.
I saw
the finger you showed.
We got in the car. Took a ride to Pound Town.
Was that the finger you were showing?
What's Pound Town? Oh, my God.
She's like, what's Pound Town?
We're not on the Facebook page.
Never heard of Pound Town. Is that in Connecticut?
In the
out of his ass?
Well, you'll find out later, right? That's what he said.
Where's Pound Town? Is that near Rhode Island?
It's got to be near Squamaket, right?
I'm just going to keep my mouth shut if I don't know something. For like, just for 5 seconds.
That's your best bet. Yeah.
No, absolutely not. You have to speak up when you don't know.
Yeah,
that's right.
Don't ever
I
fucking
always
quit.
Do.
Yeah, if you
ever
don't know,
quit.
Just say it out loud.
All right. I will, then. I will. That'll be all right.
That's what made it fun.
How else will you ever learn?
Exactly.
Well, you can read about it.
Yeah, she don't want to read it.
I keep looking at Ricky because she's the only other girl. Like, is it okay?
She ain't going to help you.
Like, Ricky's dirtier than you.
Everyone's on their own here.
Do you have any idea? What
she's dirtier than you.
I'm the worst one to look at.
We should quiz her. Do you have any idea what knuckle deep is?
Balls deep.
To
the root.
It's like the shocker.
Stop messaging me. Listen to the fucking radio. I figured
you were supposed to answer.
Are you ready?
It's like deer in the headlights. It's awesome.
Yeah.
You going to read a paragraph or no?
All right. All right. Sure. I'll go to page 22.
You don't got to tell the page.
Wah, 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 wah.
Are you ready? We'll cue you up here.
I didn't get music.
Nice.
No proofreading.
What are you doing?
I know, I'm like picking one out.
She's making a page with a dot on it.
She's looking for the smallest paragraph.
Listen for a wet, squishy noise. The distinctive noise is often a precursor to squirting. It sounds as though fluid is building up. Soon after you hear the sound, you'll begin to squirt, as long as you're not holding back.
Nice.
Okay.
Don't hold back.
Am I in the club?
Yeah. Yeah.
Mike's like, what?
You're initiated.
Who are you?
Crossed over.
Who are you?
I like it.
You crossed the line. You're
in. What do I get when I'm in my house?
She not only read it like a librarian, she looks like a librarian.
I know. I was going to say.
No, you're lucky, dude. Those glasses look hot.
I think you just found your new Halloween costume.
God,
Friday night costume.
Just got to wear a pair of thigh highs. And
I would love to spank the shit out of a librarian.
It's so loud today.
It's loud?
Because you're sitting right behind the speaker, Rick.
It's loud?
Hello.
And how does that make you feel?
Fabulous.
I can turn it down. I don't care. I got headphones. You guys can hear it okay?
Yeah, I can hear it.
Okay. Right.
Loud and clear.
What's up, Charlie?
What up?
How you doing?
I'm well.
How you been? Charlie is the guy that plays the different kind of EDM before you guys, or after you, in between you and Joe.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he actually makes his own beats, though.
That's something.
Oh, nice. Yeah,
so.
Thanks.
And he's we met him actually through
the open mic.
Open mic.
Smitty.
Nice.
I played a show at Smitty's recently.
How was that?
It went really well. It was awesome.
Good.
I think it was like the most people they ever had out there.
We've only known you since Smitty's.
So that's good.
Yeah. I met you once.
Longer.
Did you?
Yeah, I think it was cruisingspots.com.
What the fuck is that?
I think that's what it was.
I thought it was Grindr.
Yeah, we were really, really intimate with each other all of a sudden. And then we
You.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was me, man. Yeah.
Remember you asked him for that special tool?
Yeah. That was it.
That extracts porn objects. I know what turned me off if somebody said, there's been a hot dog on my ass for a week. Is that healthy? Depends. Are you hiding it for winter?
Depends on the hot dog.
I'm trying to feed my hamster.
Is that your underwear now?
I want to come up with something before we get a song from Charlie and our weekly song. I want to come up and ask somebody questions like the most useless things that are in the world right now. To me, I always find that fucking, that huge fucking toilet paper dispenser in the men's room. And when the guy puts two huge rolls of paper in
it, can't fucking
and you
got
to do one sheet at a time.
Yeah, it keeps ripping.
Is that the most useless dispenser ever?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, and then you end up like ripping little bits off.
Yeah. And then you're just wiping your ass with a bunch of squares.
Yeah.
A lot better just using
and
your
what happens with that?
Then.
Your finger goes through it.
That's my biggest
need
pain.
A fucking boat that.
And that's
boat
when you chew
then.
Your fingernail and you thought that was chicken juice.
Well, you're not washing your hands.
You need a pedicure after going to the bathroom. That's a useless fucking thing, right?
They don't want you to use a lot, you know.
They don't want you to use any, apparently.
There's fucking cheap bastard.
How about the one where you got a really white bat and fucking and the thing is stuck up there?
Yeah, you're jamming your fucking hand.
Yeah, you're like your balls deep into a fucking dispenser.
I'm up to my elbow. I still can't get no paper.
What's your useless thing, Ricky?
That's a good question.
Me?
I don't know.
Think about it. Charlie, what about you?
I need to think about this. This is a big question.
Is it?
Yeah.
It is.
How about Braille on drive-up ATM? Who the fuck needs Braille?
Well,
if you're driving the car,
that's useless, no?
Unless you're in the passenger in the back and you pull up.
Okay, I can see that. But then you'd have to go opposite of the thing and they won't let you do that sometimes.
Put her in the back seat. or them.
You know what? If someone's blind, you're going to go to the inside anyway. They don't want to be in a...
Well, my question is, how do they even find the Braille pad?
I don't know.
You're almost there, to the left. No, more left. No, more right.
Wait a minute. This,
all over
this feels like Quiznos.
You just put 40 codes in. Start over.
Those blind people get like bats after a while, man. They get like sensory radar and shit. Yeah, I swear to God. Too.
I've seen blind people walk better than normal people.
Yeah. It's really incredible what blind people can do.
Yeah. I don't want to experience it, though.
No, God, no. What the battery cover? You know when the battery cables on a car?
Yeah.
They put those little covers on them now.
Yeah.
And when
yeah.
you go to jump the car, the first thing you do is just rip the damn thing off and get rid of it
and throw it.
Never to see it again.
Right.
Those are useless.
Or you can't ever get them back on either.
No, they're impossible.
25 to 55. Oh no, go ahead.
What we bet?
No.
We're talking about the
the battery covers. Yeah, they are kind of useless.
They're useless.
Yep.
I mean, once you take them off to jump the car, you can't put it back on.
The bar that holds it down on most cars is useless too. I mean,
right.
If you're gonna do a frontal crash, what is that bar gonna do?
Nothing.
It's
first right. thing the fire department does, anyways, man. If there's anything left to the car,
they cut the battery cables. Right
yeah. okay. They just cut the battery yeah. cables immediately, man.
Yeah, I can't take it out.
I was on the fire department for years, so I know.
That's like, first step. Yeah.
The first step. Cut the cables.
Fire out.
Then fuck up this car so bad the insurance company's got to total it. You know? I was like, okay, I can do it. Give me the bike, Paul. I'll smash fucking everything. Because I'm a fireman. I love to smash shit. One time I went into there was a fire. It wasn't a fire. It was out already, but we're making entry. And it was actually people in the house. And in the garage, they had a bunch of like lawn chairs set up. So on the way in, I just kicked all the lawn chairs out of my way, right? And I didn't realize, you know, I was just launching them into the people's car and stuff, you know, and there was no reason to do that. The fire was out or nothing, you know, and everybody's like...
That's good to throw things out.
Hey, listen, Mike, you don't have to, like, destroy everything on the way in, you know. It's like, that's why I'm here, man. This is why I'm volunteering.
Yeah.
I get to like, do
well,
this.
That's the fun of it. Destroy shit. What
I just
fuck?
Left my bed. I'm going to destroy something.
My useless thing is fucking getting messaged during this show.
Yeah, that is kind of fucked up.
Streetlights in Bridgeport.
There you
They're
go.
Useless.
Why?
Because they hardly ever work.
Or nobody uses them.
No, they hardly ever work. They can't keep up with putting the bulbs back in when
them.
They shoot them out.
Yep.
Really?
You got anything, Jamie?
I don't know. That's a good question. I'm thinking about it. It's like nipples on guys. So I don't.
It's like Pete's dick.
Well, wait
That's useless.
I don't know. I'd rather enjoy it when they play.
Oh,
it.
Some
yes.
guys do.
Kathleen, you have anything while everybody else is thinking?
Can you come back to me?
You're the last one. All right, we'll go back to Ricky. Your old minister? I don't know.
I got one.
How about the car you smashed? That's useless now.
Hey!
That's cold.
I had it.
She did like you.
She fucking gave Pete a body shot today on fucking instant message.
Did he tell you?
I gave you a shout out.
Did he tell you?
What's that?
Speed racer number two.
Oh, I got it. Wait.
Bitch.
I was busting her balls about a ticket and an accident, all right? She got legitimate tickets and accidents. I got pulled over for the first time in 25 years.
Uh-huh.
Sunday.
For speeding.
Wow. Only got a warning.
But still got pulled over.
Who the fuck is pulled over from 45 and a 30?
You do.
You.
Me. No. It was 42 and a 35. That's what it was.
You.
Who gets pulled over for that?
Me.
They must have been
The guy was in the middle
you.
Of the road. No, because he got the fucking drop top. The guy's in the middle of the road going,
Was it a fucking construction site?
No.
You had the Stang with you?
I was with the Mustang, and I was in front of Golden Corral.
That's like, why.
Oh, I have one. I was secretly very happy.
She's got one. We got to go back.
She's had a good weekend. And then with Pound Town today.
Pound Town.
Yeah, but it's only a one-way street.
Next time it's Guamagate.
Where is that? Where's Pound Town? I love Pound Town. What do you got?
Okay, I have one, and everyone's going to hate me.
Your company's cable service? No, I'm sorry.
Like, what's the question?
What's useless?
Like, think about it. Cats. What do cats do? And I, what
they,
do cats
bring
really
joy
do?
To a lot of you, people.
No, they kind of don't.
What are they? But why are they here?
I don't know. I just lost a cat.
And I love cats. Trust me.
My cat died. He was a year old.
I felt like that was a really honest answer to that.
That's but terrible. You know what I mean? That is.
Yeah. My parents died.
I just had to think of something.
Yeah, but they were a useless pet. Like they're.
But what? Like, what's their purpose on earth?
Yeah. It's like, it's not like you could train a bunch of cats to tow you on a sled across the water.
Right. You know, I don't know.
They're just cute.
Yeah. So as far as worthless,
they're just
yeah,
cute.
They are kind
they're
of
just
worthless.
Cute. They're here for our.
They're here to take over the world.
I just had an answer, and that's what popped into my head.
The only thing
they look at you like, fuck you. I don't need you. You feed me, motherfucker. I don't need you.
Cats are like fucking.
I wouldn't look at you twice if you didn't.
I love cats, though.
In fact, the only time I look at you is when you when I'm hungry.
I'm hungry, fucking bitch. Feed me.
That was a bad one.
What else?
That was a bad one.
A hot body and an ugly face. That's useless, no?
Yeah.
Flip her
no,
over.
No,
or flip
no,
it.
No,
it's not all the bad.
Actually,
it's not all the time.
All right, one at a time. What?
Actually, it's not all the time bad thing.
You got to think
yeah,
about
it. Yeah, but it's useless because you're not going to repetitively do it if you have a drug problem, but you're not going to wet it or bring it home.
Peter, that's what they make flags for.
Flags?
Yeah, you throw the flag over her head and you fuck for Old Glory.
Yeah, but then what happens after?
Oh, my God.
Do it again.
Until when? You're not bringing her home to mom.
You're done.
Well, it depends. Man, it's all relative.
You
it depends on where you live, who you are. Again, we'll go back to Alaska. All right, you're in Alaska, and here comes this hot, hot bod, but the face ain't so great, right? But you're thinking to yourself, I'm halfway there, and I'm in Alaska.
I'm freezing
She's
my
got
balls
the hottest
off.
Body, so what about the face?
And that's why you never pay
she
for
got
sex.
She's got a butter face.
She looks like a shoehorn in a pair of yoga pants.
Well, you know, in a
camel
you
toe.
You can get so ugly that you're cute.
What were you saying, Charlie?
We're lovable, anyway. Say for other people that have a hot body and ugly face, or maybe the opposite.
Trailer hot though. Like trailer ugly, but model hot. Like this bitch has got fucking blackheads that look like those earrings Jamie got in his ear. But
so
she got a killer body.
What if the dude does too?
I still tap.
Huh?
What if the dude does too? Then they found each other, right?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
I like that. Okay. But hold on. If it's ugly and fixable, that's one thing. Like blackheads, no. That's fixable.
No, I'm saying ugly, like not just can't fix. Just ugly. Just like, my God.
It depends on where I'm
yeah,
at,
but
what's going
what
on.
Kind of
it's doable, though, man. It's
all right,
doable.
There's ugly where you can say, you know what, they're not that good looking. But then there's, oh, my God. Like, oh.
Yeah, but there's always going to be somebody that's going to say, oh, I like that.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
all right, for every Jack, there's a Jill. You're right.
Well, there's always a position. Doggy.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't have to look at all.
Okay. Here's how about this? Would
Baggy.
You date an amputee?
Yep.
Not post meeting, pre meeting.
Yeah.
Yes. I want one with no arms or legs, so I can just spin around my neck.
There you go. Good answer.
Good answer. Which you're looking at me like, don't answer.
Well,
that.
No. It's.
Would it not bother you inside though mentally?
No.
No, not me.
Not at all.
You? Well, what if his amputee was his dick?
Well, there's a
problem.
What
the
fuck?
Well, it depends if I love.
Then there's
him.
Her useless thing.
You know.
God bless.
Because sex goes eventually, doesn't it? Like when you get older.
It better fucking not.
Yeah. That's what every.
Was that a big yes, Ricky?
That's what everybody tells me. They're like, you better like the person because the sex goes eventually. That's what everybody says.
In this day and age,
I'm sorry.
With the blue pill and the porn, there's no reason why, other than you got high blood pressure and you're going to kick.
Well, if you're going to kick, you're going to go out.
I would definitely.
What if you have a pulled muscle?
That's the only
I
want
to go out in Pound Town.
That's what if you have a pulled muscle on the side of your body? That's a legitimate reason, no?
That is an excuse.
I can still jerk off on it, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
I had a girlfriend that thought if a guy was missing like a finger or part of a finger that it was like upped his hotness.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Really?
Because he was like a worker.
Was she that hot though?
She was like a Marilyn Monroe with red hair.
She was?
She was hot. She looked like Marilyn Monroe with red hair.
Oh, okay.
Give me that hatchet right there. Cut this finger off.
Yeah, right.
Dude, no, I'll bite it off.
I like pockmarks.
I gotta get this name off of
here. What do you like?
Like pockmarks?
What's pockmark?
Like
you mean like
dimples? Chicken pox.
Like
dimples.
Scars?
Oh, chicken
like
pox mark.
Pimples?
Yeah, okay.
I think it's, I don't know. You gives the guy
like Ray Liotta.
I just popped a pimple.
You like mean like in the 70s when they used to give you the shots and you had
no,
the
no, like on your face if you had like pock marks, it gives you an edge. Like,
right.
What's the
acne? It's
like
acne scars.
Acne scars. Oh, it looks like a 1,000 gram bar.
Like
Ray Liotta.
Looks like someone
exactly. Ray Liotta. Exactly.
You remember the movie American Me?
Or Tommy Lee Jones.
The guy
that started
that was that one.
But men are different than
rugged.
Women.
Rugged.
Yeah.
Gives
little
you
flaw.
Rugged
gives
look.
You like an edge and maybe like.
I'll be back in a minute.
He's going to go draw mine.
Yeah, you just got Bob fucking all excited.
You know, anybody who looks like they might abuse you is hot. I guess that's what she's getting
at.
I like the guy looks like he's an ex-con.
I like
tattoos,
guys with swastikas
like
on their forehead.
He might grab your ponytail, bang your head against the wall, and fuck your brains out. That's
hot. I don't have a type, though. No.
If you look like someone just fucking washed your face with Chore Boy and threw you off a bridge, I'm going to suck
he's
your dick.
Hot.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit, he's
put
hot.
That thing in my mouth.
Guy's so fucking ugly. He's hot.
Give me the ice pick and poke some more holes in his face. Look at that motherfucker smoking.
But women are different than men, though. So
can right. I play Chinese checkers on his face?
We're less. Nice. I guess we're less judgmental. Yeah. Visual.
That's a weird kind of hot, though. Like if someone had an ailment, you think they're hot?
No, I mean like just like Tommy Lee Jones or Ray Liotta. They
Tommy Lee Jones?
Well, kind of.
You see him lately?
No.
Oh, seen before?
Fuck. You seen him? Really?
So ugly, he's hot.
I'm trying to think of like.
My cousin's Dylan McDermott, and I'd like to slap him.
Like Charles Bukowski?
Yeah. How about Michael Scacco?
He's perfect.
He's cute. She's already had him.
He's got a little edgy, like, roughness.
Yeah, I'm a rebel.
I want to say he's a.
Without a clause.
Pre Cheech. Like young Cheech.
Pre-Cheech?
Young Cheech.
Young Cheech. You used to look
Cheech
like...
he's a handsome
name?
Guy.
I used to look...
Chachi.
Yeah. I was definitely Chachi in high school. I was Chachi in high school. If I showed you a high school picture, you would be... in fact, I can.
You can what, show us a picture on radio?
You can show us.
I can show you. But then it was like... I used to get Ron Darling when I was in my 20s, early 20s. I was doing stand-up in Manhattan. At the time when the Ron
and
Darling
the Mets were
for the Mets, yeah.
In the
and
80s.
And they used to be like, hey, you look like Ron Darling, who actually was from Hawaii also.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
And he went to, I think, St. Louis.
It's all these guys from Hawaii. They all look the same.
Yeah. They do.
It's a they're small
they're
island.
They're like Chinese.
You're, that's borderline. They all look alike in the projects. You know what I mean?
Just racist.
and the Polynesian women aren't exactly that attractive, but as soon as you mix the French in with them.
Fucking A right.
Oh, my God.
Thigh highs, yeah. Pair of high heels.
Polynesian women are hot at 3 in the morning when you're handing them a $100 bill.
Oh, my God.
And they got the rock.
And they're giving you a shower with a fucking... A soup pan.
A soup pan.
You don't remember those?
A soup pan. Soup pan.
Fucking Mayor Waterbury shutting them all down, prickhead.
Tom Pound.
Hey, you know they have a website now. It's called the Rub Map.
Nice.
It'll tell you.
The Rub Map?
Yeah, Rub Map.
Can I get the Wi-Fi password?
September 24th. it's a map that tells you where all the illegitimate...
massage houses.
Massage parlors are. Yeah.
Nice.
You mean the shady ones?
Illegal?
You can just call me. I'll tell you where they are.
Just look for a building that says open at 3 in the morning. Yeah. And it has acupuncture or massage on the front door.
The Bobby, lights are on.
Do your song.
Okay.
Do you think prostitution should be legal?
Yes.
We'll answer that after Bob
along
plays
with marijuana.
Okay. I know. Sorry.
I think it should, but anyways.
Marijuana.
I don't bang Ricky. Why would I get a hooker? Right, babe? Yeah. Cheers.
I can't handle that much.
I can handle her very well.
That's not what your finger looked like.
That's the plug is leakage.
Really? Oh, sorry.
Without?
All right, Bob. Bob does his weekly song, and here it is.
Can't wait. Nice.
The DJ from space is on the mix. Hurry up, man. I need my fix. Play me some tunes with your great vibe. I start dancing and join the tribe.
Fuck.
PPRN, humor, music, and talk. From that format, we will not walk.
in the words of every sitcom character in the early 90s and everyone
sometimes
in the...
Sometimes we'll get kind of raunchy, but we'll continue very staunchly.
Bitch! Bitch!
Mixtape Saturday's Charlie Beane.
Bitch!
He can play and sing like a machine.
You randy bastard!
Playing hard rock on his milieu.
Bitch!
It's so good. He knows I do.
35-year-old homosexual.
46.
I gotta collect myself here now. Michael Sacky and Kathleen Walker.
Oh, come on. It'll help you pull your head out of the oven.
They are back and both talkers.
Excellent.
We never know what they're going to say.
You don't get paid to think. You get paid to...
We're glad they're here anyway.
Yeah, this is John Glenn, Butt Munch.
PPRN, humor, music, and talk. From that format, we will not walk.
Walk, no.
Sometimes we'll get kind of raunchy.
Ha ha! Oh, called you!
But we'll continue. Very staunchly.
Put it in, take it out, put it in, take it out, put it in, take it out, put it in, take it out.
Peter is sitting at the board.
Pablo.
Burping out that we have scored.
Portuguese, Portuguese.
Ricky is always by his side.
Me.
She's so pretty that she can't hide.
Oh, my God, no way.
Casey Wilcox, while he is quiet.
Oh, here we go.
We all know not to buy it.
Let's have sex!
When the time comes, he'll make some noise.
Watch your mouth.
With that humorous complex he employs. PPRN, humor, music, and talk.
Shut the fuck up!
From that format, we will not walk.
3, 2, 1.
Sometimes we'll get kinda raunchy.
1, 2.
But we'll continue very staunchly.
We've all had about enough of this game.
Now that everyone has picked their date, it's just time to sit and wait.
Yeah!
PPRN, humor, music, and talk.
Fuck the clock.
From that format, we will not walk.
No.
But we'll continue very staunchly.
I knew I should have stayed at the
beautiful
goddamn
mother. Woo! She was staunchly. That's pretty impressive. Good job, Bear.
Nice.
Way to go, Bear. Nice. I should have stayed at the goddamn motherfucking titty-sucking piece of shit, stupid-ass dog dick-licking fucking Holiday Inn.
Thank you very much.
Good job, Bob.
All right.
Fucking
great
Uncle
tone. Bob. Yeah, that's all.
Woo. Bringing it home.
Good
again,
one.
Bob. Fucking love you.
Look at Jamie was all like, wow, he said my name. Like the Magic Garden when you were younger.
Crazy.
Right? You remember Magic Garden? When they were at the
Garden?
And I hope you had a real good time. See ya.
Yeah. See ya later. Yeah, awesome.
They would say your name at the end of it. They would go into the patch and pick your name.
Oh, God.
Yeah, they were reaching into her patch.
They were high all the time.
Oh. Fuck yeah. Secret Garden?
That was like,
that had to be growing some good shit in there.
The Chuckle Patch. That was all weed.
Yeah, dude. That's what it was about.
I think it was weed.
Yeah.
The Chuckle Patch.
All right, what was that question before Bob's song? We were going to...
Oh, it's a loaded question. I was saying, just do you think that...
prostitution should be legal.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ricky, and what marijuana. Do you think?
Sure, why not?
Oh, wait a minute.
I know they got to tax them, though, right?
What?
They're going to tax them.
He said, I know we're broke.
Well, yeah, but I mean, let's face it. That might help the...
what are you
taxed,
though? Like an overactive labia?
You tax it by the hour.
It's a service call like anything else.
Yeah, exactly. It's a service call.
$100 an hour, you tax it.
8.5%.
Yeah, but they would all have to be a 1099.
First of all, they would tax it higher than other things. You know that immediately.
Right, they would.
Because that's what the government would do. You know, just like cigarettes.
We
you know, yeah. I mean, they're gonna tax it's the hell out of it. Oh, you want a blowjob? Oh, dude, it's gonna cost you 20 in taxes and 20 in a blowjob.
Wait a minute, I was paying 25 last week. Now the taxes are kicked in. I gotta.
Would there be like a mileage tax on there?
No.
You're gonna
no.
be a
maybe
tax
on her.
It'd
be like a service charge.
Flat tax.
It'd be, you know, you got.
I think it should be legal.
It absolutely should be legal.
Well, so
they're
drinking
fucking
in
making a living. God damn it!
Look, man, it would open the doors for a lot of things. She steadfastly.
Well,
does not agree with this.
No, that's not true.
Then why did she ask it?
Because she wants us, all us men, to say yes, and then her
then
to say,
laugh at
"You're all a bunch of pigs."
Well, I think
scumbags.
It would help like, a lot of guys that can't get laid. Like,
it helps them now.
You know,
yes.
I mean, right?
Back page.
It would just be easier.
Yeah,
exactly.
But the state's not making any money on it.
Rub right. map.
That's why it's still illegal.
Actually, wait a minute. But they are making money every time they bust these girls.
But. Right, and that's like leave them alone.
It's
you know
actually
what I mean?
Costing. That will actually cost more money.
It costs more money on the state because they're doing the investigation. You got the cops. You got the
Facebook with all these.
But here's the thing: like,
another thing is, it takes women that are streetwalkers and puts them in a business where they could be watched, where they're not going to be
secure.
Whatever.
Oh yeah. Because you got to remember Amsterdam.
Yeah, but if you know, even Nevada,
fucking, yeah,
you have the money. Nevada, shit like that.
I mean, and they've got. You
medical cards.
As long as it's safe.
Yeah, exactly.
Like it's better than backpaging or driving up a street in Bridgeport and taking the least ugly
hey.
That one.
And not knowing what you're and not knowing what you're gonna catch.
That's so
bad.
No.
Yeah, you're
gonna
you
catch
what?
A fucking razor across
okay.
the throat.
You guys are looking at it as a John's perspective.
But it's better than
the
going
prostitute's perspective, it's actually much safer if it was legal.
It is, but it's better than going to that's what I'm trying to say. It's better than going to a city street at 2 a.m.
This
wondering if it's a cop or if it's not. I mean,
or if it's a guy.
Mike is very concerned about the welfare of the.
Or if you're gonna get fucking your throat slit.
Well, they walk by his work all the time. He's gotta be concerned.
Well, here's the thing: like, I can go into a bar any night, really, and have sex with.
Any guy
you want to talk
with anybody,
just let me know what that bar is.
I can walk into a bar and have sex with any guy.
No, you can't.
So can I, bitch?
Dude, I am not going home with you.
Think
you're
so special?
Just a special, you bitch.
But you're right.
I'm a handsome man. I could pick up anybody.
A lot of men are frustrated to the point where they'll like that shooting that happened.
Yeah, you know what? If you're walking in at 2 o'clock, you're gonna get banged.
Yeah,
but that's why I don't pay for sex. Because at the end of the night of a bar, there's always a fat or ugly chick you could take
that's
home.
That's true.
So that's why I don't pay for sex.
For first rule of thumb.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
For any guys out there,
no, let her finish.
For any young men out there that are trying to get laid, and
start
all,
low.
And everybody, all the men are trying to get laid. That's
bar
sure.
scene's the wrong
the,
scene.
Well, if
think
you
for
have
yourself.
Not, if you have not met a girl and gotten a number by 12 o'clock at night, go home.
No way. Go for the fat one.
No.
What's
just
wrong
go
with
home.
The fat one? Like,
absolutely
what, she's
nothing.
Just like
I'm
the
not saying
was?
That's
like,
nothing. There's nothing right. wrong with her.
So she'll just take any, you know. Just
some of
she's,
like
if she's able, willing, and ready, then let's fucking go.
Hey, man, fat girls need loving too, God.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm
good
just
love,
saying,
man.
I'm not doing them first. That's all.
Some
fat
girls,
bottom
that's
girls
nice.
They might go rocking world.
I have rules. Hold on. I have rules.
Wait.
I have rules for fat chick banging. One, they have to have one pretty feature you could focus on.
Oh, what's no. that? Wait.
Oh, it could be her nails, her eyes, her makeup, anything. One pretty focus
okay, I'll go
focal
with
point. Right. Her tits have to be bigger than her belly. And she can't have facial hair. Three rules for fucking fat chicks.
That ain't bad.
That's so fucked up.
You're man.
What it is? What do you mean?
Well, at least he's trying to fuck a fat chick. No one else is.
Right? Like, right? You just said fat girls need loving too. I may have standards
or
for fucking
a fat
chick.
Or we can just treat them like humans.
Hey,
listen, a fat chick can walk into a bar any night of the week and get laid.
Any that's chick. Right. You just said any chick.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Even ugly ones with hot bodies. It doesn't matter. Chicks get dick thrown at them. Guys aren't walking
chicks
down the street.
And that's like the joke.
Pussy thrown at them. Like the old Eddie Murphy bit.
She's right, though. No, she's right. She can go. They can go. They can go out at 12 o'clock at night.
And you get your choice. You
know, but we're not. But we won't.
But going back.
Well, some will.
But that's why that's not fair, because you get your choice. I have to accept a fat chick at the end of the night. If you walked up to the hottest guy in the room and were like, hey, you want to fuck? 90% of the guys are going to be like, yes. If you went up to the ugly chick.
Unless you had pockmarks.
Right. Especially with pockmarks, which puts you at a lower level of normal guys.
That's so not true.
So you're fucking the ugly guys, but you could be fucking the hot guys.
So you run to the bathroom, you fucking put some pockmarks on your face, you run back, I'm in.
Mike's niece just texted me. Tell him he's got the voice of a fat man on the radio.
Yes, I have a face made for radio, too.
Who said this? Somebody's listening?
Mike's niece. She's in Colorado. But, like...
Tell who?
Me.
I guess him.
Jamie.
The fat guy. The rules for fucking
fat. No, wait. He does sound like...
He's a big guy. He ain't
he
fat.
Does sound like somebody that hangs at Blackie's.
No.
Hey, man. He wait a second.
Dude,
for a guy...
I was 300 pounds.
If you got a boner... If you got a boner... And your belly covers it, and you can't see your own boner, then...
What's it called? A dicky do or something? No. There's a name for that.
Dicky poo.
I have to literally lift my stomach. Well, you not as much as used to, because I'm in the gym now. Yeah, I used to have to
That's what made me start going to the gym. When it's like I couldn't see my dick anymore, it was time to hit the gym.
I was either going to put a mirror in my tub or hit the gym.
See, I did it the wrong way.
And you hit the gym.
Yeah.
Thank God.
I went inside a gym.
I never hit a gym.
And he's called me ever since.
Same here.
He calls me once a week.
Machine.
She said she's crying right now.
Good.
Can I just say one more thing about, and I know you wanted to say about the making prostitution legal. I was against it until I'm in college.
Until you met Mike?
Until I met Mike.
and he talked you into it.
We had to do a debate, and I was given bills. Prostitution should be legal. I had to go for it when I was against it. And here I am with all these 20, 25-year-old kids, and I was like, look, I could go into a bar, get late any night, da-da-da-da-da. You guys can't. You guys need sex. And, you know, all the nerdy kids were like, you know what? You're right. We can't, you know.
We
like,
can't
we're
get
not
off
good.
Our computers.
Like, they're not smooth.
Nerdy
and
kids
and
need
when
love
we went
too.
Up to do the debate, like, I was like, they were like, Kathy, yeah. They were like, yeah, like Kathy said, she could get laid any night of the week. And if we want to get laid, we got to do all this, and we can't. You know what I mean? Yeah. So it kind of changed.
They just got to put a little effort in.
It
kind of
changed my... I don't know.
Well, you saw it from a different perspective.
What if you're like, what if you're really, 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 really horny and you want sex?
They call machines.
I mean, and you don't want to be.
You've flesh never wait,
and you want sex with a human.
Fleshlight.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And you want sex with a human.
But what were
you? Which in the
I
long
don't know.
Run
I probably sound stupid.
But this is the borderline between strip clubs and prostitution too, because you can go get a rub and tug at a strip club. And you don't have to pay as much as you would have to from Backpage.
Oh, my God, man. Really?
Man, this guy's got some...
Just giving away all the secrets.
Dude, the last...
You may as well just jerk off. You may as well just jerk off.
Why?
Because, a rub and grub. I mean, once you get that penis up in there, man, what are you doing?
Rubbing and tugging. Tugging up here, you're rubbing down there. 1, 2, 3. Have you met millennials today? Do you see what's going on, Pokemon going?
They do a lot
These
of
guys, the most they can
Pokemon
do is go to a strip
going.
Club and
oh
home.
God,
yeah, because
scary.
You know why? Because they all got carpal tunnel from texting someone.
They know their thumbs and their, that's it.
Yeah.
Their expats.
Calling Rangoon. Calling Rangoon.
Let's get a song from Charlie.
Calling Pound
your age, Bob.
What do you got for Charlie? Yeah.
There's only three people in a plan even know what you're talking about.
You're right.
And I'm one of them.
Yeah, you can hear it.
Sounds like porn.
Porn.
Love it. Oh, hell yeah.
This is Pound Town soundtrack.
That is, yeah.
Isn't that next to Musquamica?
I'm chubbing up. Chubbing up.
Chub, 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 chub,
Is it what?
Is it fine if it's long?
It's better if it's long for her.
That's what Kathy said. It like better be long. Man.
It this better fucking be long. And you better
You're
have some pockmarks, motherfucker.
We're not going to CVS, are we?
Like I think it's so
Kathy, look at
this. Now I want to watch movies.
What purpose does this fucking serve?
No,
I love cats. I do love cats.
All right, Charlie Bean's going to do a song for us. He's
all right, Charlie.
Actually chopping and screwing something today. Is the volume all the way up on your laptop? There you go.
There you go, brother.
I want to just bring Ricky upstairs right now and put everybody back in my head.
Yeah, me too. not Ricky.
Yeah, man. It's a raining man.
That pussy.
Thank you.
Great.
Oh, yeah.
Just goes to show you, it doesn't have to be loud to be good.
Right.
That was beautiful.
Ain't that the truth, Ricky?
That was fucking
very
beautiful.
Cool.
Well, yeah, but it makes it a lot
I make more noise than her. I think I'm the lady. I do. I'm more than her.
Maybe you have to make me.
Now, do you write that down?
Gut punch.
Maybe he another needs gut to punch today. Seriously, Ricky.
Challenge.
Body
you
shots to fucking Pete today. Wow.
Challenge.
Do you make that yourself? Yeah, obviously.
Holy fuck.
Is that what you give us on Saturdays?
So this is the stuff I put on Saturdays. So
sweet.
It's a group called Even Odd. It's me and two people, well, me and myself and my friend Kevin. And he programs a lot of the beats and manipulates them live. And then I kind of just write over it.
Sound great.
Or we'll, like, combine. He'll have, like, a progression. And then
so do you write it while you're playing it? Or do you just fucking freestyle on the guitar the whole time?
No, I can play those parts exactly for what they are, you know. So
that's awesome,
I write that, you know, I have the whole progression down and everything like
that's
that.
So that
sounded
crazy.
Great.
It's very cool.
Thanks. Yeah, I can't wait to listen to playback.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, we have all those tracks online too, like, you know, actually.
And every Saturday, Jamie.
I was leading into the plug.
Every
Saturday.
Every Saturday.
The day before Sunday, motherfucker.
It takes me a half hour to do that whole playlist at 10:30 every Saturday.
And then
don't be afraid to
there's
join
a producer,
the
YKD, though, that does, like, all the mixing and mastering on the tracks. These aren't fully done yet, though. There's, like, these are the tracks we're working on right now. So
nice.
They'll sound better in a little
all
while.
All right. Tell your friends. Let's go. Tune in. It's 8 o'clock hour. We're going to take a little break, pay a couple bills. We'll be back with the live feed and some more whatever talk.
Shenanigans.
And some more Charlie
shenanigans.
Bean.
Shenanigans.
Some more Charlie
we're
Bean.
We're going to Pound Town. Next time it's
Pound Town. If you're on live, go to pprnradio.net.
Don't be scared.
That's right. We're going to cut you off, like, right now. All right. We'll see you in about 7 minutes.
Hey, guys. It's Peter from PPRN. Looking for something to do in Naugatuck? Check out D-Man's Bar and Restaurant. It's a local hub offering delicious gourmet burgers, wings, wraps, steaks, and more. Stop by and enjoy their casual atmosphere sitting in the bar, the lounge, or dining room. Or kick back on the patio. D-Man's is located at 1370 New Haven Road in Naugatuck. That's 1370 New Haven Road in Naugatuck. D-Man's is going to be broadcasting live PPRN radio show on Wednesday, July 20th. Go down and check out the PPRN radio show broadcasting live from D-Man's in Naugatuck, 1370 New Haven Road, Naugatuck, Connecticut. That's 1370 New Haven Road. Go check out their patio, their bar, and their lounge. They have great food, too. Also, don't forget to check out D-Man's throughout the week for drink specials and local talent. Once again, check out D-Man's, 1370 New Haven Road, Naugatuck, Connecticut. Tell them PPRN sent you. J&M Automotive in Naugatuck, Connecticut has been in business for 28 years. They stock over 450 quality pre-owned cars. They have the highest quality cars with haggle-free price, complete financing for all credit scores. They take all trade-ins. They are rated with the Better Business Bureau AAA. They were voted CTI ADA Quality Dealer of the Year. Visit jnmautomotive.com for cars, pics, videos, and descriptions. jnmautomotive.com. They're located in Naugatuck on 756 and 820 New Haven Road with over 250 cars in the lot. Call them at 203-723-5 6666. That's 203-723-5666. Also, go check them out on New Haven Road and check out their website, jnmautomotive.com. And tell them PPRN.
Did you just hear how bad that sounded? Well, you won't get that sound at Hat City Music Productions, located at 536 Federal Road in Brookfield. CEO Chris Litwin takes your music to the next level. If you're tired of those basement recordings, those people that you pay too much money for and have you get out within a half hour, well, you won't have that problem. Hat City Music Productions, once again located at 536 Federal Road in Brookfield. Go check out Hat City Music Productions. You won't be disappointed. Tell them PPRN sent you. Ah, fuck! Ah, fuck!
Hey, dude.
Where did you get this vegan stellar water pipe?
At Shock and Awe in Waterbury.
Where?
Shock and Awe Smoke Shop in Waterbury. Dude, don't tell me you haven't been there.
I don't know.
Listen, you gotta go there. Shock and Awe is way different from those crappy mall stores. They have some sick-ass glass pipes from crazy-ass glass blowers. And get this, they even have a community art gallery where they host drum circles, poetry jams, and they do music, too.
Wow, no way.
Yeah, dude, I'm telling you, they have everything down there, even medical grade.
Dude, I'm down. Where is it?
I told you, it's in Waterbury on Huntington Avenue. Just get off exit 36 from Route 8. Here, I've been following them on Instagram for a while, Shock and Awe Smoke Shop. Take a look at this picture.
Wow, man, that rig is ill.
Yeah, dude, I'm telling you, they're always posting new shit.
Dude, as soon as I get my car back, I'm heading to Shock and Awe.
Hey, Matt, you need to write a commercial for your Dotted Supply.
Okay, we'll promote our grinders, bats, or the Hancock dugouts.
Well, our one-handers and our dugouts are already super popular.
Yeah, people can definitely see the quality difference.
Right, so we probably don't need to focus on those. But our premium grinder's brand new, so why don't we go with that?
Cool. What features should we hit on?
Well, it's a kick-ass grinder and getting rave reviews already, so we could use one of the testimonials saying it's the best grinder they've ever used.
Nah, that's cheesy. Let's stick to the features.
All right. So the key is really the sharp teeth.
And the holes.
And the number and the size of the holes.
Yeah, they let the herb fall through without getting jammed up in the chamber.
Right, because nobody likes the weed traffic jam going on.
There's also a Teflon ring that helps the lid slide easily.
And the super strong magnet in the lid.
And the pollen catcher.
Ugh, we're never going to get through all this in 60 seconds.
Well, just ask them to follow us on Instagram and Facebook, or visit our website at www.greengoddesssupply.com.
Are you located in the Middlebury area?
Or the Waterbury area?
Check out International Wine and Liquor at 750 Straits Turnpike, located next to the subway.
Or JT Wine and Liquor at 952 Chase Parkway, Waterbury, Connecticut, next to Spartans.
Both have a wide variety of beer, craft beer, scotches, bourbon, vodka, cognac, and rum.
And a large selection of wines.
Once again, if you're located in the Middlebury area, check out International Wine and Liquor, 750 Straits Turnpike, next to the subway.
Or if you're in the Waterbury area, check out JT Wine and Liquors at 952 Chase Parkway, Waterbury, Connecticut, next to Spartans.
And let them know that PPRN sent you.
Oh, man. Can't take this shit no more. Where the fuck my headphones at? There you go. Ain't nothing like being able to shut that fucking shit up with my soul electronic headphones. Yeah. Now this is peaceful. Soul electronics. Headphones inspired by Ludacris. Soulelectronics.com. Get your pair today.
Hey, what's up? This is Randy Boyer of En Masse Music and Boyan and Boyer, and you are listening to the PPRN Network. Turn it up.
This is Shawny Sean.
This is Vincent Price.
This is Ill Will.
And you are listening to PPRN.
From where?
Body Count.
What's up? This is Levi from Miss May I, and you're listening to PPRN. Stay metal.
This is Doobie from Whitesnap, and you're listening to PPRN, you fucking wanker.
You're listening to PPRN, motherfucker.
I am not really Antonio Banderas, but if I were, I'd be listening to PPRN.
Starts with thunder, quake, birds, snakes, an airplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid. I have a hurricane, listen to yourself, turn world, serve its own needs, dummy, serve your own needs. Beat it up and out, speak, run, no strength. Ladder, something flatter, with fear, fight down. High fire, represent a seven game. Listen, coming in a hurry with the Furies breathing down.
Just jumped up to 25.
Team by team reporters, bevel chunks, other crop. Look at that low plan. Find them. Uh-oh, overflow. Population common food, but it'll do. Save yourself, serve yourself. World serves its own needs. Listen to your heartbeat. Done with the rapture and the reverend in the right. Great. Bitch out of cage, out of slam, but now. Feeling pretty sight.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine.
Six
turn, listen to yourself turn. I can in here for me, foot burning, but let it every moment escalate. I'm gonna incinerate, light a candle, light it, put it. Step down, watch your heel, press, press, uh-oh. This means no fear, cavalier, renegade, steer clear. Tournament, tournament, tournament of lies. Offer me solutions, offer me alternatives, and I decline.
It's the end of the world as we know it.
You're listening to PPRN.
I am not really Antonio Banderas, but if I were, I'd be listening to PPRN.
Oh, yeah. Welcome back. I love this song. I'm going to save it for the next... Hold on. Lips Like Sugar. I don't want to play it right now.
I
love that song too much. I don't want to waste it.
Lips are like sugar.
Lips like sugar.
Which lips? Which lips?
Okay, so coming up in another month,
old people.
Roller skating at Roller Magic. They're having a huge
reunion.
Yeah, let's
break our elbows and shoulders, everybody.
There's 4,000 people confirmed on Facebook that are going. You can't fit that many in the parking lot.
Huge. Wow.
For what?
Roller skating.
It's a parking lot?
No, it's
Roller Magic.
Roller Magic.
That sounds dangerous.
But 4,000 people are confirmed to go, so I don't know where all these people are going.
I haven't been on roller skates since fucking
better get there early if you want to go.
Wipe the fuck out then. I ain't getting
roller derby.
It's actual roller. No roller blades are allowed, no.
Nice.
You either bring your own.
Old school.
Either bring your own or you bring.
I love rentals. I love it.
And I'm gonna go there and I'm gonna use a pair of rentals and I'm gonna do like I did when I was 12.
Are you gonna wear a jumpsuit too?
I might.
He's totally gonna break his
Me and Ricky have been practicing the wheelbarrow race.
There we go.
I want that slice of pizza. You crazy?
I guarantee you, we gotta put a pool on this. If Pete's gonna break a bone or not?
All right. Here's the problem. Our wedding is like.
That's what I'm saying.
2 weeks after that.
Yeah, and he's going to be in a cast.
You'll be fine.
I'll be fine.
You feel like you're not getting out of the
cast. I did that in eighth grade.
Wait till you see this motherfucker on skates. I'm telling you.
When's the last time you skated?
Exactly.
It doesn't matter. You don't forget.
It does matter.
It does.
When was the last time you were on a bike?
It's like riding a bike.
I still wipe the fuck out.
It's different.
The first time I got on it, I fell down.
Listen, you don't forget. That's not the problem. The problem is your body doesn't react the way it used to.
Dude, you're going to break something.
No.
Let me ask you something.
After the performance this morning, I ain't worried about roller skating.
Peter. Peter.
Oh, you should have seen my hips.
Don't listen to any of them, man.
You should have heard his cries in pain.
What did you weigh the last time you roller skated?
80.
Half of this.
80?
Three quarters of it.
Okay. That's what I'm saying. Okay, now if you fall, it's going to hurt.
A lot more.
I'm telling you, watch.
Your bones.
I'm going to do a live video. Watch. I'm going to go back when I was dancing. I was on a dance team. I don't know about the speed team. I don't know if I can hit the 80 miles an hour mark yet still. But
can you go backwards?
Yo, fuck yeah. Sideways.
When's the last time you went backwards?
It doesn't matter. You won't. I'm telling you, roller skating is like a bike. You do not forget.
I play hockey.
That's
so
what I thought.
I play roller hockey, so it's the same. It's similar, but
I agree.
At least you're not on rollerblades.
You don't forget.
No. I'm a goalie, so I use quads.
Nice. Yeah. I was a goalie, too, for field hockey in college.
There we go.
Word.
Field hockey.
It's always
hot chicks. Fucking with poles.
Yeah. Hot chicks with poles, yes.
Skirts.
Skirts.
That's skirts, yes.
Skirts.
I didn't get a skirt.
Hot dogs.
Legs. Let's get back
nice.
To
those. Very
nice. So what were we talking about?
Are you going to have a light stick?
Yes, Bob.
Roll
bounce. Gonna, like,
wait a minute. The light sticks are not the same as they are now.
Oh, they're not.
The light sticks back then were fucking poisonous.
Yeah, you
you bit down on those motherfuckers.
You had to
go
to hospital.
And
these little pussy
alive.
Ones now.
And we're still alive, right?
You used to swing them around, remember?
We'd we used to put shoestrings on.
Damn, dude, you live dangerous.
I was sick, dude. You know what?
Dangerous.
I was so sick.
He used to shoot a fire rocket right in the air and just stand right there. He didn't care if it hit him or not.
You know, that's like...
You
know
what?
Suicide.
I
was so sick on skates, I went from backwards to frontwards and backwards and sideways.
What? Sideways? How did you do that?
Did you flash
it up? You never skated sideways?
Do you, like, do the little...
Do you have shiny shit? Did
you
wear shiny shit?
Put your feet like this.
Wow.
Heel to heel.
Heel to heel, yeah.
And then I went home after I got out of skating.
Oh, heel to heel. Okay.
I would skate for 20 hours, literally.
Ricky's wishing you could still do that.
Wow.
Skate Odyssey, the old Colonial Plaza.
Yeah, I went every Saturday.
Backwards,
forwards,
how old are you?
Oh,
please.
I'm not telling.
You're my age, right?
No.
Higher?
Younger. No.
Oh, man.
Holy
younger.
Shit, that was fucking rude, man.
You're lower than 46?
Savage AF.
Oh, my God.
Then that's where I fucking know you from.
I'm definitely not 46.
I told you I knew you from somewhere. I used to go to Skate Odyssey. My brother was the
man. Fucking lived there.
He used to bang my girlfriend.
I used to go.
Used to bang my girlfriend.
Maybe.
He tried
fuck
to.
My girlfriend, man. Really?
Yeah. We were touching tits back
then.
Well,
we would trade off. Like, mostly it was Skate Odyssey, Roller Magic.
Yeah.
Well, Manny was my brother. He was the manager there.
I cracked
there.
The bone of my elbow. I was done with
he
it.
He went from Skate Odyssey to Roller Magic, then they opened Studio 60.
Would you recognize his penis? I think I was too little.
It's like really brown Shafton with a pink head.
You're not little now.
Oh, God. No, I mean, like, I was just, like, worried about, like, my cotton candy and my light stick, you know?
But anyways, we would fucking, like, go there, and that would just be our hangout.
Wait a minute. She just said we're really fucking old.
I would stay for all three sessions.
Right.
The morning skate, the afternoon skate, the night skate, and then I would even stay for soul night.
How old were you?
14.
I want to say we were between 10 and 11 back then.
No, I was like between 12 and 14.
No, 12 and 14 were Hillside. There was already
the one
closed
they had
down
Salem.
No.
We should do
this was in Waterbury.
We need to do a 10 and 11.
The one they had downtown.
Let's do a 10 and 11. You know what that is?
Remember?
Yeah.
What were you doing at 10 and 11 years old?
He wasn't fucking your girlfriend.
Right.
What were you doing
at 10 and 11?
I was smoking pot in the woods.
Playing gigs at 10 and 11. What were you doing, Jamie, at 10 and 11?
I have no idea, man.
Bob don't remember.
What were you doing?
Atari.
She was like anybody that would call me.
I was playing baseball and smoking weed and drinking.
See, I'm from New York, so like I was taking trips into the city. I was talking about that the other day.
Brothers and sisters.
I don't trust my kids now to do what I did when I was like 13 years old.
Yeah, but you can't put that on them.
Well, yeah.
Wait a minute. Wait, that's
the drugs are fucking more.
Wait a minute. You can't tell them.
We smoked weed.
You can't tell your kids not to do what you did.
Put that on
I
them.
I don't trust, like, today's kids. Like, you're talking about, I bit my glow stick and fucking died. Like, they don't
that
have.
That was back
we're
in
still
the
alive. We're still alive,
I know, but
alive,
everything's
though.
Padded. They have, like,
I'm
plastic yellow trucks.
I bit my glow town. Stick and died.
You know?
You like, can't even buy a toy gun that looks like a gun.
A gun anymore. You can't even take the little red part off. Yeah. They make that as part of the plastic. So
they're spray painting them now.
You cannot. You listen. Whatever your kids do, and my mother, I want to rip my mother's teeth out when
don't
she
says
it.
Don't contradict her.
You did this to me, and she says it in front of them. I'm like, shut the fuck up. You can't say anything when your kids fuck up. Like, she does it now, too. She's like, hey, you probably did that when you were your age.
Of course we did.
Well, I'm just saying, like, I used to take the bus into the city and go and throw in headphones and roller skate through New York City on a Saturday afternoon.
If they weren't lying.
Yeah, no, I can't trust my kids to fucking go up the road to get milk.
If they would do that, then that's fine.
But why? You can't trust your kids or society?
My kids.
Is there somebody on the phone?
You're live on PPRN.
Speak.
Hey, is this Pete?
It is.
Yes, it is.
Hey, buddy, this is Joe Riley. How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing fine.
Are you Pat Riley's brother?
It's good. What's going on?
What'd you do?
What'd I do? I'm on a radio show right now.
No, he meant what did you do on the week? What did you do this
weekend?
What did
you do this weekend?
What did the fuck you do?
You went to New York.
Had the flu.
Had
to New York.
Six
Flags.
Yeah.
You went to New York.
Why, what else?
Trying to hide right now. What are you hiding? What'd you do?
What did I do?
What'd you do, man?
What did we do, man?
He's
what the fuck do you
you're
know
on
that
the,
we don't?
Like he's the prosecutor right now, and you're on the stand.
What
did
you
do this weekend? We know you did something.
We went to Pound Town.
Six Flags. Golden Corral.
Six Flags. Golden Corral. Pound Town.
Sexual deviant, Pete. That's
Pound Town.
And what's the problem with that?
You're a sexual.
And what's your name?
I can't hear him. Hang on. What? What'd you say?
Pete, how was your weekend? What'd you do?
You said that before.
Is he on repeat?
I couldn't hear because I need like silence so I can hear Pete. I want to hear from him.
Okay. I Six Flags. I had Golden Corral. I went to go see my friend in New York. And
how's he doing?
He's doing good.
How's your friend in New York doing?
Good. And I went to the hospital Friday night for the emergency room.
Well, what happened?
I had a flu.
You had the flu?
Yeah. What are you wearing?
Well, you're fine. You're fine now, right?
Yeah, what are you wearing?
What am I wearing? I'm wearing pants, dude.
No, to wear to your ankles?
I'm wearing
or
jeans, dude.
On nice. A fucking night like that.
Wranglers or what brand?
Dude, they're Carpenter jeans. I got the little like hammer loop on there.
That's
I keep
hot.
A hammer on there sometimes.
That sounds hot.
Yeah.
Our heart is off.
But can you tell us what color blue they are?
You don't know what brand.
Yeah.
What was that?
Can you tell us what color blue they are?
Light, I'm not very dark. Good with colors, man. She's a dark blue. That's
you don't like colors?
He's not good with colors.
Are you voting for Trump?
It's dark blue.
Oh, dark blue. Nice. Any zippers?
Like ball blue?
I mean, it's just like the crotch zipper. There's no extra zipper. Like, no weird, like,
what's your name,
out of left field you weren't expecting. It's just, like, regular. The crotch zipper of my dick can come out.
Joe Riley.
How are you?
Hey, Joe, do you have any relatives named Brenna?
I do not.
Oh, okay. How about McIntyre? Does that sound familiar?
Does not.
Okay.
Come on, Pete. Let's just stay on topic here. I'm talking about you.
All right. So we said it like eight times.
Is this
this
is your show,
set the
right?
Rules, bitch.
He's nasty.
He's nasty, right?
Yeah.
We want to hear more about you.
Nasty. Mm.
Dude,
what are you?
I want to know how your friend was, man.
Are you Janet Jackson nasty or just nasty?
Come on. You don't got to get weird. Just tell me how your friend in New York was doing.
He's doing very well. Why?
I'm just curious. I want to know about you, man. I like your show.
Oh, thank you. That's kind of weird.
Now you're, like, now you're trying to just, like, I don't know.
Don't get angry. We went through this last time, mister.
Yes, you've called before.
Yeah, you remember? You remember him, right, Bob?
Yeah.
You get very angry quick.
I'm a big fan, and I'm always just, like, verbally assaulted by you. I don't
No.
That's what we do.
How can you be a big fan and not realize you're going to be verbally assaulted calling in?
Come on.
That's like having your tongue in my ass and saying you didn't know it was there.
I just want friends so bad. Please be my friend.
Dude, come on down. Just bring weed and beer.
Man. If it's that important, just come here. We don't care.
Yeah. Bring a fifth.
Wait, I come down?
Yeah. Come down.
Of course.
Yeah.
Bring your sad pathetic
Listen, come down, but
down
we're going to do a background check first.
Listen, he sounds like
you
somebody we're going to see in SVU.
We have no beers today. We're drinking.
Oh, I don't know, man. I eat a lot of beers before I go anywhere.
Well,
drive and drink, man. Don't do that.
Don't be silly.
Don't be silly. Wrap your willy.
Don't be blacking out at the wheel.
Come on. Wait,
believe
hold
me.
On.
Believe me.
Are you not drinking because of the flu?
No, I'm drinking again.
Meditation?
I'm going to go on.
We're drinking.
I'm going to go on Facebook Live so you can see our faces. How's that? Is that good for you? Does that make you wet? Moist?
I can fire
it does
up
a little. Sure.
Dark blue eye is getting...
Jamie, take over for
Hi.
Hi. My name's Jamie. Okay. I'm an alcoholic and addict.
But he wants to talk to you. He doesn't want to talk to me.
Jamie?
Hi. Jamie. How you doing?
Yeah, Jamie's one
What's
of the
up,
guys
Joe?
Who does the mixtape on Saturdays.
You can be my fan.
How are you, Jamie?
I'm well. How are you, Joe? So, Joe, what are you doing right now?
Super.
What are you looking at? What's in front of you?
His phone.
My yard.
What's in your yard? Name three things in your yard that are totally useless.
All right, well, there's some of that weird, shitty, like, brittle plastic lawn furniture shit that everyone's got. There's a pitchback that no one uses.
Guys with blue uniforms walking around rifles.
Pitchbacks rule, dude.
You don't use your pitchback? You sound like somebody that totally gets backpitched.
Hey, my pitch back when I was a kid gave me a black eye.
Hold on. Wait a minute. Does that have another meaning to it?
No.
Be
no.
honest.
Be honest.
Wait
a second. We're on the radio.
You called us.
You
tell us something interesting.
We want to know about
you.
Wanna,
you want friends, Joe. I need to know why you want to be. Why I should let you be my friend. I'm cool.
Your moral responsibility as a person with, like, the reach that comes.
How tight
radio,
are your
Joe?
Jeans? Are they regular jeans or tight jeans?
Skinny
you sound
jeans.
Like somebody with skinny jeans.
Nah, dude, I promise they are so relaxed. I have to constantly pull them up and adjust my belt. They're very relaxed.
So you've got shitty lawn furniture and you don't wear clothes that fit. Why should we be friends?
How many times a day do you masturbate?
How many times?
Yeah, how many times a day? This is Mike. Joe, talk to me, man. How many times a day do you masturbate?
And do you use toys?
Like, one time I'll sneak off at work, into the bathroom, lock the door, and you know.
Wait, what do you mean you lock the door?
I'm sorry, I didn't.
Who knows?
That was awesome.
Do you use a computer or your phone? Or television?
Huh?
You sound like somebody that might still have some DVDs.
Church is going to come by.
Whatever is in front of me that I need. Imagination, phone, TV, anything. I don't care. I'm not picky, dude.
Have you been listening the entire night? How do you feel about prostitution? You sound like somebody that would be all for it.
Legal prostitution.
Legal prostitution. Legal
prostitution.
Legal. So that way you can walk in the same way you buy your jeans.
Well, and relations like that are sacred, in my opinion. But
how much did you drink tonight, Joe?
Oh, nothing. That's a lot. I wanted to sound cool.
What are you smoking right now,
Joe? What time do the meds get passed out?
What's up?
What time did the med car come by?
The med car.
A little while ago.
Did you get a day pass or?
I thought it was good. Wait, you guys are starting to badger Joe again.
So
I don't
want to
pick on
Joe.
He's going to get
I can talk now.
I'm interviewing.
Joe's a good guy.
I can talk now.
Jay,
because
you're doing a good interview.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Keep going.
He's
doing a good job.
It's an interview. Like, you want to be friends? Let's see why.
No badgering, Pete.
So now back to this masturbation thing. Do you use a fleshlight?
Fleshlight? I mean, I'll, like, roll up a towel around, like, a latex glove.
This just got fucking real weird.
Wait. We could learn something here.
Yeah.
Yeah, how do we creepy?
All right, so we got towels and gloves. Go.
Two.
He was explaining.
I know, I cut him off, and I apologize, Joe.
He cut you off, Joe.
All right,
no.
so far, I've got you in tight pants that don't fit.
No,
with shitty lawn furniture.
No, it cut me off, so I'm done.
No,
35-year-old homosexual.
Come
don't
on.
Be nasty.
I agree with Joe. I think Joe's right,
with the jerk-off
situation.
Joe, don't be nasty.
I think Joe's right.
All right, so we got a towel and we've got latex gloves.
Wait, he wants an apology.
Oh, I'm sorry, Joe. I don't mean to upset your process. I want to learn your process. So we've got imagination, towels, and latex gloves. Go.
Where does
the bathroom come chains.
You know, chains.
Whatever.
You change yourself?
Nice.
Dude, that's pretty extreme. How old are you?
Kathy's got her mouth open for some reason.
How old are you?
It's kind of weird.
Do you have pock marks?
Hey, you are so fucking in, dude.
That's what I say.
Age is a number, huh?
It is. Don't you agree?
Above or below 18.
Exactly.
You know what's
you
a real...
Judge on your age?
It's not a number until you're 16.
Joe, you know what's a real...
Why don't we all forget that?
You know what's a real turnoff for women? Is when a guy's cock is half brown and the top of it's pink.
Yes.
Yeah, it's really weird.
Absolutely.
Right? Yeah.
It's called the mushroom.
Yeah, but that's a pink mushroom is not right.
No, nah, man, it's
that's
like it's the black stem pink mushroom.
It looks
mushroom.
Like a pencil top with a top on it, right?
No, yeah.
Yellow one? No, not yellow. Yellow
one.
You got jaundice in the cock.
You've got yellowing of your cock.
We love cock, Joe. Do you love cock, Joe?
Hey, Joe, are you on Facebook?
Well, I mean, I got one, sure. Yeah, I got one. I like mine.
Does your cock look like a varicose leg? Or is it, like, really nice and smooth?
Zany.
Did you tell Joe how he can get the live
We're looking for a penis description.
Yeah, we want to, like, know what your cock looks like.
It's part of the friend
interview. Now, if you guys won't cut him off, and please let him.
You're upsetting my delicate sensibilities with that vulgar question.
Well, you know what? You went really, really, like, muffled, so you must have your cock in your hand and a pillow around it. You just like this and all, though.
Don't judge me.
There you go.
Yeah, that's Joe.
Hey,
we called
you
out.
Doing,
on Joe.
Now microphone. Go get your fucking shine box.
I can do what I want.
And I
yes,
don't
you
care.
Can, Joe. Yeah, you can.
Fucking of course you can,
yes, you
Joe.
Can.
Who said you couldn't?
The little bus is going to be coming around the corner.
Pete, what exactly
wear your
did
helmet.
You do on Sunday, though?
What did I do on Sunday? I did my sports show until 1.
And you went to New York.
And then I drove my son to Litchfield, and then I drove to New York, and then I came and saw Bob for an hour, and then I came home.
Damn, you're a busy guy, Pete.
Yeah, and Ricky
fucking
wanted
right.
Pound Town, and I fell asleep.
That's good, man. Got to keep busy.
Yeah.
That's some Musquamic jerk off.
What's this guy trying to do? Like, are you trying to kill me or something?
It's like a Maury Povich thing. Yeah. Like, and we have
this in love with you.
I got to admit, Joe, you got kind of a creepy voice.
I'm sorry I'm scaring you with casual conversation, guys. Sorry.
Hey, Joe, have you picked the date for the
wait, 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 though. Wait, Joe. Casual, Joe. Casual conversation doesn't want to know where the fuck I am every second. Casual conversation is more like, well, no, casual conversation.
Go on Facebook
so you went out with your son. Okay, not like, what did you do step by step? That's really kind of weird.
But casual conversation
why
is,
that is weird?
Not for the radio.
Because you know what?
You've been step by step on Sunday.
Hold on.
So
I'm
going to
explain.
I'm
going to explain to you why you sound weird. Because you go from nice.
How do you know about it?
Hold on. You go from nice to a little bit irritated to mad to fucking really irritated. And then back to the same Joe again.
Rage monster.
Yes. It's like a he's like a bipolar.
Hold on. And what is the common denominator here is that you guys provoke me.
We poked the bear.
You sons of bitches.
Well,
you
know, the thing is, Joe,
guys,
is that you're easily
I'm
provoked.
Cannon,
but, Joe.
I'm teetering over the edge, and you're just fucking with a loose cannon right now.
Okay.
So, you
now,
saying, wait, you
a man that could use legal prostitution.
Wait a minute. You saying that, should I give you my physical address then?
What's that?
You're saying that when you're fucking pissed off. Should I be giving you my physical address knowing you're angry?
27 Frederick
Street. Yo, go to the nearest prostitute and get a blowjob now.
62 Manners Ave.
If I killed you, I couldn't hear your show.
Oh, yes, you could. They got the repeats.
I would like it to fuck there, motherfucker.
I really, no, seriously, on a serious note, I really appreciate that you listen to the show a lot. But you're not going to like me in a couple of months because I'm getting my teeth fixed and I'm going to sound normal.
What?
Yeah. You cannot change your voice.
No way.
You're changing the voice.
Yeah.
Dude, you are your
Why?
Voice.
What's wrong with
you,
your
man.
Teeth?
Oh,
they're fine. It gives you character.
Better than fucking my
it
shit,
It gives
though.
You your voice. Is your voice going to change?
I won't have those.
Are you getting
you
braces?
You got to have that.
Are you getting braces?
No, I'm going to probably get them all ripped
you
out.
You sound like you're drunk all the time.
No, wait. Are you like killer veneers, dude?
Wasn't he?
Hmm?
Yeah. Yeah. I thought he was.
Can I get a little support, please?
Yeah, no,
it's the first time you heard my voice.
I listen.
Wait, what'd you say, Joe?
Sorry, we're ignoring you now.
If you're getting veneers, are you going to go natural, like a little natural yellowing, or are you just going to go straight up? Just
I don't know. I'm going straight up white like I just came out of the vagina.
Oh,
yeah. Fuck, yeah.
Fake pearls.
I'm with Ricky, man. This kid is SVU destined.
Yes. Yes.
Joe, when you burp, does it smell like penis?
Semen?
Semen?
I mean, not 100%.
Oh, okay.
Hey, man, have you ever been committed or something? Have you ever, you know, are you
sexually active with a man?
Honestly, I mean, you don't have to give it up,
dude,
man.
Dude, I'm never keeping you alive. Are you kidding me?
I'm just saying, hey man, I've been sent some places myself, so I can relate.
I'm signed up.
I'm not trying to make light of anything like that.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I've needed help at times. It happens to everybody, man.
That's
I mean,
right.
Not everybody, but certain people like you know
most
me.
Everybody. Most everybody needs it. They don't.
No, there's always a time. There's always a time when we stress.
No, certainly there are some people who it would help. You know.
But Joe,
I totally agree.
Seriously though, when you call up places like not just us because we already got to know you. You can't call up and ask people what they did for the day because it scares them.
It does?
Yeah, man. No, doesn't it scare you guys at all?
I feel like
know
he
every
had something
detail.
On you.
Yeah, like he was
on,
watching me.
Yeah, like
he was like, no, you weren't at Six Flags. I saw you.
Maybe he's just naturally socially awkward and just has to be taught. And if he calls in once a week,
then we're going
to
help
him.
No, not me,
him
man. I'm a social
Has he been listening so far?
You're
I gave him some great
butterfly.
Advice. I mean, earlier, though, I gave him great advice to help him get out there so that
right.
way, you know,
yeah.
we can get Joe's needs. Because it sounds like his balls need to drop. Joe needs to go to Pound Town.
Joe needs to go to Pound Town.
You know what I'm saying? That's the theme.
Not just you, babe.
Yeah.
I'm trying to tell you this. It's not just you.
Everybody needs a trip to Pound Town once a day.
Fucking ain't right,
Thank
I do.
Come
you.
On, guys. Come on.
We all do, Joe.
Well,
all
right, so
well, we're trying to, Joe.
Come on.
Joe, we're gonna let you stay in our conversation a little bit. We're going to move on a little bit. Let's ask the couple here. What is a healthy sex drive for a couple?
At least once
I'm
a day.
I'm
hold
way,
on,
way more horny than she is.
That's you know.
Right, let's. Oh, come on.
And she's shaking her head now.
That's not true.
It is true.
That's not true.
What should be at least how many times a week?
Me? Three.
I'm asking
Three.
Healthy. What's healthy, though?
Three.
Healthy is like.
Three.
Once a day.
It's like workout. It's workout
That's
time.
That's freakish.
Do you work out three times?
Freakish.
It's not freakish.
Do you work out three times a week?
20.
You're 30-something.
Yeah, so that's not freakish. Like, men, women hit their sexual peak in the 30s. Men, we've already accomplished that, like, 14 to 26. But, like, you should still be able to bang them out once a day.
I think it, like...
What's healthy for a couple?
If you have low T, I mean, they do everything for that now.
9 times a week.
Well, we've had it once a week for the past 2 weeks, and Mike's complaining. But it's just circumstance. It's working.
I didn't hear complaints.
You know what I mean? But it, the quality, I mean, come on.
No, see, that's different, though, because if you're a couple, you can plan a date night,
the quality,
but you should still throw her over the couch.
The quality is good.
So
would
you
sometimes fuck in the pitcher throws?
The quality over quantity.
Okay, hold on.
You can't have the quality with too much quantity.
It's incredible.
You know what I mean?
You guys can't have
get a fastball.
You guys can't have conversations on conversations. Hang on. Say what now?
I'm just saying you can't have too much. If you want quality, you can't have too much quantity.
And Bob made a judgment or a reference to eating pussy because no one heard that because everybody else was talking.
And what was that?
So once a week, is that okay? Is that not enough?
That's not enough.
I don't, like, I mean, it could be for that week.
It can't be enough. Say it, more. He's
he's just trying to get an okay.
He's just trying to get an okay.
Oh, that's all he's looking for.
Babe, do you hear me?
He wants to
bust.
How much do you want to have? Vindicate.
But no, that's what I'm saying. There's a, like, hey, now I got to do everything myself.
See,
I'm
I think
Pete,
that
what's the right answer?
When I want it.
There is no
right answer. No. Because then that would be like once a year.
If I'm lucky.
Lucky.
At least once a week.
Wait a minute. You know what? She makes wait, hold on. Woo. She always takes pot shots. You get it at least once a week. I don't want to fucking hear. You can have it like, well, be like
she
other
said
couples.
If she's lucky.
When I was married.
No, she gets it once a week.
When I was married, we were hitting it about four times a week.
See, and I'm with that.
So were, after, wait a minute. So were we.
Remember, I was married for 20 years.
So were we until shit started. I got sicker. And then I had to, you know.
So sex was making you sicker?
No, the pills I had to take.
Is Joe still here?
Yeah, but then you bounce back.
Well, then you take another pill.
And then PPRN started getting more. And then PPRN started getting more stressful now that. See, once that's gone, it's going to be more stressful.
I think healthy sexual relationship once a week should be like date night. Heels, fucking whips and chains, everything to keep it spicy one time a week. And the rest of the time, two, three times, you just want to throw her over the couch, spontaneous,
like
and bang it out.
It's called maintenance sex.
It's called maintenance
yeah.
sex,
yeah,
man.
The maintenance sex. Yeah. Yeah.
You know,
that's
in the refrigerator.
So three to five.
And maintenance sex is some of the hottest sex you're ever going to have because it's like,
God,
hey, I need some
right.
maintenance.
Wait, what about... when she's cutting a salad for work over the counter sex.
Just don't get it in the salad.
Why not?
Yeah. No, I don't. Listen,
any
I don't
sex
shoot
spontaneous.
Any sex.
Yeah, anyway,
counts.
Spontaneous sex, car sex. Everybody should have car sex once a month.
But she's working at the counter.
Pull over on the side of the road and just knock it out.
We do got a convertible.
That's what keeps relationships healthy. That's the juice and the fruit.
Charlie, you're
that's
young.
Nature,
what do you
brother?
Think? I just want to sex period.
I don't know.
Yeah, man, look at him.
I don't even fucking want to be part of this.
What? You're on the radio, man. There's girls out there listening right now that are like,
on,
that guy's music
mic,
was amazing. He's let fucking good looking. I need
I
to know.
Yeah, you just dried up like 10 pussies. All
right, so you have a girlfriend. So how much do you throw it in her?
Like once a week.
Thank you, Charlie. All right, we'll see you guys tomorrow night. We'll see you tomorrow night.
How old are you, Charlie?
Thanks, Charlie.
I'm 25.
Thank you, even better.
Oh, my God. No way.
Dude, I'm
he gets an orgasm
even with
from his
my
music.
Girl. I still tap her three times. Yeah,
is that your choice or hers?
Probably my choice. I probably want it less
than me.
She does, which
what?
Is weird. Yeah,
no.
Wait. Do you have a lot of stress in your life?
Yeah, it's stressful.
All right. Do you work a lot?
I work a lot.
And you obviously mix a lot.
I love
and make
music.
Music.
That's all
tired.
I really
there
do
you go. When your mind is busy, that sex is the last.
You
thing you
already
want.
Called me the hardest working DJ in Connecticut. You know my schedule. I'm still trying to get it in three to five times, and that's not even self service with the fleshlight. This is
yeah. But do you live with someone?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know when you go home, your girlfriend's breaking up with you, right?
Hey, look.
she's banging somebody else over here that doesn't do that.
It's like
when I was married.
I got her fixed.
You finally said something. You said all the wrong things.
When I was married, didn't matter what time it was. We both hit the rack. We went at it.
I listened to the words that are
and I mean,
under.
Sometimes it was just playing around, but every night there was something going on.
There's no better way to relieve stress.
Let's just cut around. Let's cut around everything. How big's your dick, Bob?
Well, you mean now or back
baby
then?
Arm. Baby arm. Baby arm bar.
Wait, he loses a lot of blood.
It might be 5 inches now.
No,
but
he
back
does
then it was around six.
He does lose a lot of
six
blood.
Six and a half.
So, yeah.
six and a half. But, you know, hey, she was. She didn't want to go.
I got 6 3/4.
Apparently, I knew
right
how
over,
to use
I'm
it.
I'm right over you, brother. Just above average.
It's all about.
All
right. Besides that, there was a tongue.
We seriously got to do this over talking. We got to stop that. But you don't even want it at all anymore, even if it was given to you, correct?
No.
You said that last week.
No, I haven't.
Did he
had
not?
It. I haven't had it. That doesn't mean I don't want it.
You missed it, Bob.
You said, quote, I don't want the headache right now.
Right now.
Right now.
It's a simple defense mechanism.
It's a different day today.
You're not getting laid.
Today, he'll take the fucking headache.
The fact of the matter is, if I could find the right person, I'd be all over it.
We've tried to hook you up twice, motherfucker, with my mom and her mom.
And all I had to do was hear your mom talking to you to know that wasn't the right connection for me.
So then what about her mom?
He hasn't met her yet.
How are you pimping out moms?
We'll get there.
We got what?
Pimping out moms.
I will find somebody for you.
My mother.
We know somebody for him.
My mother's still upright.
Catwoman.
There's a fucking. Bob is going to be complete.
Listen, my mom's still upright. I'm hooking that bitch up with anybody. I need her to stay healthy. I need that money.
There you go.
God bless you, Peter.
I got a condo in Waterbury. You waiting for me? Love her.
I love you, Mom.
I love you, Mom.
Love you, Mom.
No, my mom. My mom's 75, and she walks around better than I do.
Yeah.
And I wanted to, my mother gets very lonely. I can tell because that fucking TV. As soon as cable goes up for a second, oh my gosh, she's calling me because that's her only form of communication. So.
My mom's turning 80 in October, and she just found love. Real love for the first time in her life.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
It's true.
Hey, Mom, or Bob, I can find my mom for you. He wants me to find him something.
Yeah, and the guy doesn't know that she's 80.
Does she look 80?
No, not at all.
Does she smell 80?
No.
Joe, what about you, dude?
Golden fingers.
Joe's still there?
Joe, you still there?
She's the healthiest 80-year-old you've ever seen.
Sorry, guys. I was vomiting from all the gutter talk.
Joe, you're not very nice.
You got to swallow that when it comes up, man.
Dude? Don't be a spitter.
Oh,
man. You're just dialing up the sickness now.
Are you watching the video, Joe? You're not watching the video, Joe?
I don't have a computer.
Oh, so you just got a track phone?
Yeah, the phone's to my ear, so I can't really look at it.
Is it taped to your head so you can have your hands free?
At the same time, it's kind of hard.
You got a speakerphone?
Do you have like a ghetto hands free with the tape to the head?
Dude, it's bad.
Isn't it a bad
situation over here?
You want me to talk dirty to you, Joe? Should we do phone sex?
I can't believe he's still on the phone.
If you start and you keep going the whole time and I don't say anything, I'll do it.
Oh, you got to say something.
Will you finish on
phone
sex?
We got to do this now.
Phone sex is a two-way street.
That's right.
That's it.
You can't be quiet during phone sex because it's two-way.
You got to know what's
happening, say something, you say something. I say something, you say something.
So we start off in the kitchen. You're on the couch waiting for me.
Yeah.
I'm frying that butt.
Yeah, I'm frying up some taco meat, Joe. Oh, yeah, we're going to have some fun, buddy.
Are you a plumber?
Ricky shredded me some lettuce already. I'm going to bring me a little putty knife, you know, the ones the Masons use to build walls. Yeah.
Oh, I know the ones.
That's right. Yeah. I got you laying on the couch now, and I'm using the spatula knife and the taco meat to fix the crack in your ass. It's like a brick wall. It's like
you're gonna need a little more to fix this thing, man.
Oh well. I fried up 3 pounds, buddy.
3 pounds.
I'm taking all the meat. We got the thing all smoothed out now. I just emptied the bag of yellow cheese on there.
Ooh. Cheddar.
I turned on my blow dryer just so it all melts the cheese just right. You see it bubble?
Don't be scared.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're not done melting the cheese. Hold on, rewind.
All right, rewind. I want you to fart for me, Joe, so that meat goes projectile all over my face.
Oh, my God. Man, you ruined it for me, man. You just ruined it for me, Pete. I was there with you until that, man.
Projectile.
You know, you always
I'm out.
It. You always ruin it.
I know. How do you not ruin gay sex when you never had it? I thought taco meat and the crack was good.
That was good.
That's disgusting.
And it's Tuesday. I mean, you were there.
Taco Tuesday.
You were right there.
Please finish.
He's still there.
So goddamn broken.
He's excited.
You know what? You're so broke, so let's change it from meat to...
Spam.
Aldi's mac and cheese, 3 for $1.
Oh, there you go.
Aldi's mac and cheese.
Yeah.
Wait, first of all, across does the whole country know about Aldi's? Aldi's is great.
What's that, Joe?
Are they global? Is
hold
Aldi's
on.
Global?
I don't
know. Global.
Yeah. I'm going to pound hold you, now. And you're going to pound me. A pound of macaroni.
A storm is brewing?
Now.
You want it hard or soft?
Stop it.
Up to you.
What?
Up to you. You decide. I'm still off the ride here.
Hard, please. Fantastic.
Give it to him, Pete.
Put it in, take it out. Put it in, take it out. Put it in, take it out. Put it in, take it out.
Yippah, he cry. Food is meal, food is cry.
Give him what he wants, Pete.
I am.
Don't be a scared.
No, I'm scared now. Charlie's going to throw up. I don't want to make Charlie throw up.
I'm not going to throw up. Don't worry.
You sure?
Yeah.
Are you getting excited or are you getting mad?
All of a sudden, he's going to go
home. Neither.
Again. He's
going to go hear home more tunes by Charlie. Charlie, those are
all right, let's get out of the game this because it's 8:49 and have a song from Charlie again.
Yeah. We got to hear a song.
Can I?
Joe, well, say what, good to fuck
Michelle,
again.
What do you want to ask Joe? Because he's over hot and bothered right now. You know you want to.
Kathy.
Kathy.
Michelle, Kathy.
Michelle, I just want to unhear what I heard.
You want the last 3 minutes of your life back?
Yes.
Too How late. Can I
it's deleted. Too late. I don't want them back. I want them deleted.
Life just keeps happening. They hit the play button, and that's it. There's no rewind.
This means you're not coming back.
I'm
you're
coming back.
Fucking on play.
I'm wondering when the new season of SVU starts.
Who's that?
Oh, my goodness.
SVU?
No, who's saying? You're asking me that?
Yeah.
Acting?
Probably late September.
Okay, we'll see Joe then.
Pete.
No, dude, it starts October 13th.
Oh, thanks, Joe!
Oh, he knows.
When's your episode?
He does.
It's already
been recorded. Pre-programmed.
When's your episode, Joe?
Joe, yeah, exactly. Which episode is yours, please?
I completely
please?
Just spat out a random date. I have no idea. Sorry.
All right, let's go.
Thanks for the call, Joe.
We're going to go talk to Charlie right now.
You're welcome. No problem.
Bye, Joe.
I love you guys so
much. Me too, man.
Love you. We enjoy you too,
Joe. Keep calling.
Taco Bell, Joe.
The love's going there, Joe.
Keep calling, brother.
You're totally cool.
Yeah.
Go.
Huh? No,
you gotta.
Yeah.
You didn't raise your hand.
You cannot go pee no more. Ever again.
If you walk to the top of the stairs, there's a great pee through that.
You can never pee again, okay?
Can I pee? Yeah.
No, you gotta hold it forever and ever and ever.
Chew gato.
You ready,
Charlie?
I'm ready. All right.
Willing
and able.
All
these tracks are produced by Kevin Tye and mixed and mastered by YKD, the legend. I won't be able to hear my vocals.
Can
you hear that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We can hear it.
Sounds like
yeah.
Nose spears?
No, I guess.
walk out to the lighthouse in time. Footprints in the sand, even by the tide.
All right, that was Charlie Beane. Nice. He's our mixtape DJ, and he's also got his own acoustic stuff. We are going to take a little break, commercial free, and
sound
be back
good,
in about 8 minutes.
Awesome.
It's Duke Whitesnap. You're listening to PPRN, you fat wanker. Like the storm, grace on the water, lips like sugar, lips like sugar. Just when you think you've caught her, she glides across the water. She calls for you tonight to share this new life.
in your eyes. See the thorn twist in your thighs. And I'll wait for you.
Hi, we're live and we're kicking ass. Format upgrade, change, whatever you want to call it. We got the round table tonight. Charlie Beane heading the music.
Good job, Charlie.
Oh, yeah. Love you, Charlie. Awesome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me again. I always appreciate it.
Bob, awesome to begin.
I always think that when you're here, you get mad.
No, not at all. Man, I just don't know how to join almost in on some of the conversation. That's all.
Is that why you look angry?
Do I look angry?
No, you were like, I ain't fucking talking about that shit. Get the fuck up.
Don't get Joe mad. Just, you know, get a little pissed off. Joe goes over the top, man.
Joe mad.
For everybody to tune back in that we haven't heard from in a while, Jay Silpin said hello. Yada.
Yeah.
What's up, Jay? Bob, what's up on the chat room? Alejandro. Fucking look at that.
Good numbers.
Sir, thank you people for listening.
Thank you people.
Triple digits.
Yeah.
Love it. Fucking love
you
people.
That's good.
Triple digits.
They're only tuning in because I started talking.
Exactly.
That's right. It's all Ricky's fault.
Give Ricky and Mike.
Did you see the thread today?
Fucking asshole pedophile.
Did you see the thread today? She can be funny.
Yeah.
Peace the fuck out.
I know. Yeah. I loved it.
That was two shots to the fucking body, baby.
You
want to
know,
put a lot of
that's the
down
first time I've seen her on the thread, too.
Oh, yeah.
I don't chime in a lot.
I was in the supermarket laughing
either,
my
so
balls off. I'm like, oh, that's a body blow right there, baby. Yeah,
it was good.
Yeah, we're on.
We're on.
Why are you asking him? He was in the same place you were.
I know. He's having this like deep analytical conversation with me, and I'm like, we got to go.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
What were you talking about?
Oh,
hold on. Stop the music. What were you
analytical
talking about?
I was knuckle deep. Admit it.
Wow.
Wait, on what kind of knuckle?
All that.
Yeah, what were you talking about?
You want to smell?
Our relationship.
Oh, is it going to end? Because I need to know, because
it's
I got to put
continue
you on Tuesday, you on Wednesday.
Yeah, because we got to have you both.
Got to have you both. I can't have this break
one
up
one way
shit
or the other.
No. No,
you're
breaking
both
up
coming back.
No breaking up.
Are you breaking up?
Is it my fault? I know. Well,
Wait. I think they are.
Are we?
No. Not at the moment.
Wait a minute. Come on.
No,
are
we? We're not.
I may have to.
We already had one breakup this week. We can't have another.
No. I may in the near future have to move to Colorado.
Oh.
School, where in Colorado? Oh. I have a.
This is why I don't get close to nobody.
Weed is legal.
This is why I don't get close to anybody. And you got to stay because you're
I just trying to find out what he's talking about.
I'm curious, where in Colorado?
So, and you got to stay. That was the conversation.
All right, Charlie's got a question.
Where are you moving to in Colorado? Probably a place called Montrose.
Some place where he can smoke.
Outside of Denver. It's all legal.
Everywhere. No, actually, I want to apply for the hospital over
there. You
so
go.
If I can get a job there, then maybe.
I love it out there.
Listen, you ain't going.
You can't smoke weed.
Mike, you're not going. The minute you get on the plane and she's not next to you, you're going to be a crying little bitch.
I know it, man.
You're going to blubber.
I know it.
You know what she's going to do? She's going to take five napkins
and, she'll fucking
and wipe her vagina
out there. Oh
and put it in your lunch bag. So when you go to wipe your face after eating your sandwich, that's going to remember why you're going to be staying back. Stop the plane! You're going
to
be like,
back to Connecticut! Let me out, I'll fly myself!
She follows you out there.
Wasn't there a Fruit Loops commercial? Follow my nose.
Yes.
Yes.
Wherever it goes.
Her vagina's going to be two cans.
Well, whoever makes the money, isn't that who you follow?
You
isn't that the way it goes?
She works for a major company, though.
Okay.
Get transferred.
So they're staying here.
Oh, okay. But you're going to Colorado. I'm just trying to.
I'm going there, with
listen,
Mike.
Don't they have an office out there?
It's either.
No.
Legalize it.
My best friend just went to Colorado, so like, it seems to be the tits thing to do.
Are we? No, but wait a minute. Are we hitting a nerve or?
No.
Okay.
They're getting watery eye, right? You're seeing it?
Yeah, I do.
That's, okay.
Who
so
is me?
Both are.
You look, and you know why? Because they're both answering questions with questions.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's like tough. A politician.
Yes.
Yeah.
You they're both, they look like windshield wipers. They're both turning their heads.
Are we?
Same time.
This is like breaking news to us.
All right,
today.
So when do you plan on leaving? This year?
There are no plans like that yet. Today
we haven't broke
today
out.
Was the very first discussion of, hey.
One blowjob, dude.
Why?
You're
why do you
want
to go to Colorado?
Dude, I do not want to leave her.
But what?
I know
just
you
a job.
Then don't go. Is it a job thing?
It's a family thing.
Oh. That's cool. Is someone ill?
No, but
is someone little?
Someone's old.
Oh, okay. And you want to make sure? Okay.
And
you want to go help take care?
Can I suggest something?
Yeah.
Skype.
No, long distance. This is a generational long distance.
It is.
I had to make the decision to move from Chicago to New Hampshire. For a similar reason. My mom needed
Chicago
to have somebody else in the house. And it was like, hey, I really didn't want to leave my kids. Okay, but they were all old enough so that they really didn't want to spend a lot of time with me either.
So you've been through this.
Yes. So
wow,
I can fully
this is therapy
empathize.
Now, man. I love it. Bob, man, let's just let it all out.
It was
let it rip.
It was a tough decision.
Joe's listening. Yeah.
And 9 years later, after I made the decision to move out there, then she needed to have 100% care, and she moved down to Connecticut, which is how I eventually ended up back here.
God bless
because
you, did.
My sister was taking care of her, couldn't handle her 100% of the time, and needed a little help.
So
you made big life changes.
So,
all right,
I moved to Connecticut.
Connecticut.
So wait a minute. You guys decided to talk about this the night of the radio show?
Because of all the sex talk.
It just happened. It just like happened, earlier.
You know, did your like vagina did it all dry up like a cotton ball?
No.
Oh my
God. And you can even like the hard part. You can now do clones. You guys can clone each other so you don't even have to worry. You can Skype. All right,
so
sex.
Here's the thing. Your career is going to keep you here.
I mean, I...
It has to.
At your age, you really can't just leave and go somewhere else because your company's not in that same state. Correct?
Okay.
All right, because you don't want to go work for AT&T or somebody else. You can't. No one, listen, I worked for cable for 25 years. I'm still trying to find a job in either Frontier or a cable, and they won't hire me because of my age. They don't want a 45-year-old technician.
46.
So. That's the, you know, and that's the problem.
That's the problem. So she can't just go. That's the problem.
I would just go, but I don't think it's really about family and a job. I think we're just breaking up.
Oh, damn. Mm. Real?
Where's the soundboard for this?
There's a surprise on his face. Just
please.
Saying.
Hey, do you have to move?
He didn't know that.
You have to move over here?
Are you mad at me right now?
Yeah, I would be.
Wait a minute. Did someone cheat?
Matt? No.
No.
That's good. That's
you don't do that, man.
All right, that's good.
No. I don't even want to be with another woman. Are you kidding me?
All right, good.
No, but family and job is a factor.
How long have you guys been together?
A week.
3 years on August 17th, it would be. Yeah.
Okay,
you
so listen.
Fucking follow.
All right, so right. Wait. No, wait a minute. So you're both in love. It's been 3 years. The sex is good.
Yep.
The relationship is fun.
And you're fucking old.
Are you with each other all the time?
Well, we work.
You live together, right?
Yeah.
Okay, but you're with each other. Wait a minute.
There's a Beyonce
wait a
song.
Minute.
I'm
wait.
Now.
Wait a minute. You like being with her or no?
What's that?
All the time. Because when I said you're with each other all the time, you're like,
no, it was a smile with a nod.
He made the eyes.
From
his
perspective, it was a happy smile.
Okay, so let's get that ground. We're trying to repair this.
Pete's
so
going to ruin everything.
This is a good
you need to leave.
You shut your mouth. I've been with her right, every day since I met her.
Thanks, Jamie, for telling me.
I don't even remember what fucking the sky looks like since I met her.
You shut your mouth.
So you're with each other all the time, so think about it. I want you tomorrow. I want you to go. And I want you to fucking go away for 3 hours and not even pick up your phone and think about her. And see what your life's going to be like for 3 hours. Because that flight is going to be 3 hours long. Right?
It's like
flight?
Six.
What do you mean flight?
No, Colorado's five. Sorry.
No, 5 hours.
No, it's a 2.5
hour drive. It's
3 hours.
A 2-day trip.
California's five.
2.5 days.
I think we're talking about moving. I'm talking about packing all my stuff into a truck and taking my truck and putting it on a thing.
So this is what I want you to do. I want you to take a large moving box and make believe you're putting stuff in it. Bring it to your car, close the door, and go somewhere for 3 hours and just park. And don't even look at her. You can't talk to her. You can't say nothing to her. And just think about what that's like for 3 hours. Because that's going to either keep you from going or make you go. Can you do that for us?
This fucking intense. Jesus, man.
Right or wrong?
You're telling me I get a 3 hour
ride? I can't be without her for 10 minutes. I don't I ain't gonna lie.
Wait, so I get it.
Except
what
she's working.
That's what it's about, though.
Hold on, let him speak.
Go ahead. Let's go, Mike.
All right, Mike.
So what are you saying? Like, if I get a 3 hour break from her?
Can you do it?
Not a break.
I welcome it.
Left turn. That totally didn't go the way we were going.
Left.
Right? Totally left turn. Now playing left field, Mike. So if you get a three-hour break, what we're trying to say is that you can't live without her, so don't move to Colorado if you really love her. That's the direction Pete was going in. You're like, fuck it, I'll take 3 hours away from her. Shit.
Absolutely, yeah. I'll take three hours. I'm trying to get 3 hours. If she'd give me 3 hours away from her, we wouldn't be in this situation.
Oh. Wow, maybe you are correct.
We're getting
real. Oh, man. Savage.
So do you want me to help you pack, or?
There it is.
I can understand that.
No, wait.
But Mike,
no, but wait, come on.
Oh, wait a minute. So you can't be without her, but you're doing nothing to stay with her.
Excuse me?
You're not going to do the three-hour thing tomorrow.
The three-hour away from her?
Mm-hmm. I don't think that's long enough.
Well, yeah, it's 3 hour break from both of you.
It works both ways.
I understand trying to be independent and on your own. That's one of the things that bugs me with a relationship. It's like I'm constantly just like, I'm now somebody else's person and I'm not my own, and it fucking drives me insane.
Oh, God, I'm Ricky. All I'm 100% Ricky.
So, yeah. What do you so saying? I think, I'm so I think the relationship is kind of in the same boat. And
well,
also,
yeah, but you've traded Ricky for your drugs.
Not necessarily.
That's a great point.
A little bit.
No, because that means I wouldn't love her.
In the long run.
No, I stopped drugs because of Ricky.
Yeah.
Right.
I didn't trade them for Ricky. That's the difference. I stopped because of her.
No, there is a big difference, Bob.
It goes both ways, though, because addiction allows you to just shift addiction. Ever meet somebody that was addicted, and then all of a sudden they're a gym rat, and then they start working out? So you're just changing your addiction. So I understand what Bob's saying.
Yeah, I'm
you're in love. I'm not. Yeah. I'm not saying that.
That doesn't preclude love, but what it's become is your focus.
Oh no, I'm always addicted to something.
Yeah,
addicts like always
now,
are at it.
I'm not saying that it's a bad thing.
Now, if I miss a day at the gym, I'm upset. Oh yeah, like we haven't gone in 4 days.
That's
like,
a good addiction.
I'm like, what
upset
the fuck?
Too, because your belly's getting a little bigger.
That's what I said to myself. I said, can you imagine we haven't been here in 3 days and I'm fucking getting bloated already. if I don't go to the gym. So I told her, I said, fuck that. We're going Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday straight. Fuck you. I don't care. You don't want to go to.
So, Mike, do you need this break? Are you focusing on Colorado just to get a quick break to see what it's like without before you take that? I just watched the show Master of None.
Right.
And, like, the whole thing that. Do you watch it? The whole break that he takes, and, like, she goes away to Chicago for a couple of months, and he realizes he can't live without her, and it was 4 days. And then all of a sudden they break up because she decides, fuck
yeah,
this.
Mike, we're trying to save
we're
you
trying
from
to save
all that money.
I'm just trying to wrap my head. Tonight's the first night I met you, so I'm trying to
figure
out where
we're at.
Because
now if you go over there and then 2 or 3 months go by, you're starting to say, well, I want to come back. She's like, well, you know what? I got used to you not being here.
No, I think that, I think one of the discussions today also was her.
Besides, I need hosts.
She was in. No, man. We could work together.
We can call it in.
We can work together as a team here easily.
Talk to us.
The one of the things that we discussed was that she was in a 9-year relationship and then went from that to a 3-year relationship, and she's been in relationship for the last 12 years. And in fact, that. She might need some time at herself, and she kind of agreed with that. She's like, because she seems to want more time to herself also, and to be free.
Okay, so there's something going on to where you guys, one of you needs time away for a little bit.
What did you call it?
A break? Fuck
there,
that.
There is a fundamental.
I need some new dick.
Are you trying to eat, pray, love, or are you guys just taking a month off?
There's a fundamental.
I'm doing
There's
the replay.
A breakdown
I
here.
I like
hearing.
That.
Absolutely.
There's a fundamental flaw.
She's like, I'm
we, have a funda-
we have a
fundamental.
There's
have
a fundamental flaw in the relationship.
What is it? What is it?
It's really we can't tell you. I don't know.
Okay.
I know what it is, but I'm not gonna.
Does
say
it have skin and blood wrapped around it?
Why do we have to?
Too much time together.
Well, now we gotta know.
Yeah. Right.
Fucking tease.
That's not it.
Damn.
Dick's a little
awesome.
Mike.
That is amazing.
Yes,
it's a good
is.
Thing you didn't
it.
Say it.
That's
huh?
not
Touché.
It, she said. So you're all right.
All right, so wait a minute. This is what my opinion. You could stop me at any time. You both spent a lot of time together. It's been 3 years. You both can't live without each other.
You're invested.
But right now, you want to beat the fuck out of each other. But you don't want to break up. You don't know how to. It's a figure of speech. You don't know how to tell each other, look, can we just stop for a little bit? Because you don't want to break her heart. You don't want to break his heart. Am
You're
I wrong?
Living together,
or?
Too.
Yeah, kind of.
So is Colorado the
okay,
excuse?
Okay, good, because that scared me. I thought I was right.
So is Colorado the excuse that gives you guys a little space for a moment, some breathing room to figure out the next?
No, if I'm not going to be with her here in Connecticut, I'm going to change and go to Colorado. But she's the only reason why I stayed in Connecticut.
Oh, and she feels the burden.
No.
Yes. She's laughing.
My God, Peter, you're a psychologist.
I love it, man. Peter's
Throw your hands
on
up.
It right now.
In the air, wave them around.
Thanks,
like,
Jamie.
Just don't care. She snaps in a circle.
Yes. Casey is a better host than Phil.
Wine.
Can I just say that?
Fuck Phil.
Yes, I'm saying you're better.
What's going on?
Thank you, brother.
Pete playing Dr. Phil. I like it. Dr. PPRN.
All right, so, but here's the thing. Let me tell you what's going to happen.
Okay.
You're going to take your little breaks. You're gonna do whatever you do. You're going to do your little I want of this, I want of that. At the end of the day, you're both going to be fucking miserable.
No, I think that we're going to probably. I think we're probably going to separate for 2 years, 3 years at tops.
Ooh, no, I hate that word.
That's so scary, man. That's the scariest shit in the world.
If she goes to work, I'm a mess.
No. And what?
And then if our lives don't change, and she gets her career to where she can retire because she has had an awesome.
It's all about career and stuff, but
well,
fuck,
I mean,
man.
We're talking about retirement and being happy.
Yeah,
know,
yeah, no, absolutely.
Retirement, and she can't avoid that. She can't. And
it's
an
RSVP.
If I'm doing what I'm doing in Colorado, and
well, it's not that far away. Colorado, you could do long distance, like a couple of months here, and you come back. If you're going for family, then you know you go take care of what you need to,
and
come back.
And in the long
run, I'm telling you, you're both making a mistake.
You're being selfish about
yourself. You're both being selfish. You're both being selfish.
You know what? They're going to do what they need to do. They're going to do what they need to do.
Ricky's talking.
No, because it seems like they're both kind of feeling the same way. So if they're both feeling the same way, then I don't think it's a mistake.
Right, sometimes you got to take the break to make the scene.
We were both waiting for the other person.
Wait, what's Charlie got? Hold on. I want to hear the 25-year-old point of view. He wants to get laid tonight.
Because he's going home about to do the same thing.
He doesn't want to talk about relationships.
That's okay.
Come on.
You shut your mouth the minute you tell me you need any kind of fucking break. I'm done.
No,
fuck that break shit.
But if they're both feeling the same way, then there's a problem.
Especially after like serial dating.
And it's all about at this point figuring out, you know, what the next step is.
So what got you to the point where you both felt the same? That's how you fix it. What got you to the road where, like, I don't...
Sex once a week. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Everybody drives that new car because until they pay their payments off and then they want a new one.
Or until they crash it. And the funny thing is, it's not even about...
No, we're making jokes. You guys used to love to go for rides together, and all of a sudden...
We still do.
It's a figure of speech.
Oh.
You guys both of them are supposed to be in the same car together, and now all of a sudden you want to get a new car.
Right.
You just got to change the tire.
No, I don't want to get a new car.
They don't want to get a new car.
Wait. She
they don't
said
want
right
cars for a while. They
no,
want to get a bike.
Right, I understand.
Oh, okay.
They want to get a bike.
Understand the analogy.
Okay. We're trying to fucking save you. A, because we need
Look
both.
At me. Like, I'm all cross-armed
well,
right now.
You've shut down.
What were you just going to say about the car?
I don't know what I was going to say.
This is why I don't get close with nobody. This shit happens every time.
About a new car?
The only thing...
You said you don't want a new car?
No,
the only
I don't
thing I don't understand is
paint
that
the car.
He says he doesn't want to be with anybody else. That's the part that has me a little confused.
Ooh,
I really don't.
She's.
I mean, in a sexual way. In a sexual way.
Wait, emotional's even worse than fucking sexual.
Emotionally,
an emotional friend is worse than sexual friend. Sorry.
Can we get some weight on? We got callers out there. Let's open the line.
Can I play a song?
123 people.
Let's go. Somebody from 123 call in.
Well, there's a lot of people in the same place.
Yeah, there's people in 134 now.
Well, I mean, what do you do? I mean, we've all been in relationships. Sometimes, you know, at some point you go, you know what? There's just something isn't.
Yeah, and that's when, you know, when you start to teeter totter, pick it apart, blah, 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 end it. Just totally end it and don't look at each other ever again.
Yes. Yeah.
No,
you have to.
That's how we are.
No,
I'm like you.
There's no being friends.
Fix it or fuck it.
You can always be friends.
Yeah, but you know
you're
what?
Wrong, Pete.
You
you're
can
wrong.
Be friends,
But you're not going to talk to each other for
you
a good year.
You could be friends and you can care about each other the rest of your lives.
Of course you could. Of course.
So
yeah, but you're
going to
be acquaintances. It's not friendship.
But you know what? When you become friends and then you see her out at Shamrocks and you're at the other end of Shamrocks and she's having, and you're over there.
I think the only way
it's going to suck.
The only way it can happen is I've got to leave. She's the only reason why I'm here.
Then work on it. Fucking fix it now.
Yeah, but he has a reason. He's got Colorado. He's got a family thing. And it gives a space for a minute.
Hey, look. And
doesn't hurt to change it.
And she's getting a little twinkle in her eye thinking about, you know, being single.
For a minute, yeah. She may, don't.
She needs it.
Think about the other way.
At the age she's at, which is not that old. Oof. At all. Sorry. She needs, I know where she's at because I was there 10 years ago.
But do you think you need it?
You know what I think you guys are both doing? You're both making excuses so it doesn't hurt as much. But guess what?
Absolutely.
It's
hurt
a lot
why can't
worse.
We do that?
No because it's going to hurt a lot worse if you're
no,
lying to
yourself.
No, it's
not. Shut up.
It will.
I could bury emotion. Dude, I could bury it so far.
I could bury my cock in my mouth, too.
Alcohol.
But I ain't doing it.
Root, Mike.
Prove it. Prove it.
To the root.
Hey, Mike. You have no idea. It's not that easy.
Thanks. You see, now you're in denial already. She ain't even gone yet. And denial's not a river in Egypt, bitch.
You're an asshole.
Yeah. Well, a lovable one.
Yes, indeed.
Hang on, let's keep this. We'll get to one thing.
What is this?
Give
therapy
me 2 minutes.
It's a therapy show.
Yeah, you know why? Because we just got a new fucking format going. We wanted to include everybody in it. And now fuck that shit. You can't leave for at least a year.
For this.
It's gonna be a while. We can come on. You know, it's gonna be.
Wait, so you're doing this now? You're doing this now?
No.
When are you doing
PPRN?
Wait a minute! You broke up with her at my house?
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, kind of.
You were outside?
No.
Oh.
No.
Freak.
I was listening. Did Pete just break us up? Pete just pronounced
I'm Professor
it.
Guggenheim.
That's the laugh. I love it.
Jamie,
laugh.
Did that just happen?
Is that next
time? I'm Professor Guggenheim.
It feels that way.
And the only one that saw it was the young kid over here.
Wait a minute. What? How did I
he
break
hasn't even
you
been through life yet. He saw
he
that
did,
coming.
Based
he
tried
on
to say
the start of the conversation.
He's like, he's been the whole time.
You wouldn't let fucking right.
People fuck this up for you right now.
I can't feel anything because I've had a bottle of wine.
Okay, so listen. You're not
that's how we'll both black out, and then it won't matter.
I think listen,
until you re-listen to the podcast.
Hang on.
If you don't remember, it didn't happen.
I think that's the issue. You guys both drank a bottle of wine.
No.
I'm telling you,
so
wait
now
till
you're
tomorrow.
All emotional?
Wait till tomorrow.
And take
don't
a 3 hour
think about
tour.
It now. You
how
guys
jealous would you be?
Let me tell you something. Thank you. Let me tell you something. Wine fucks your head up.
Yeah, oh, it might set
one glass will fuck your head up.
Of course.
Right now, you guys are thinking with this. You're not thinking with this. Relax. Have a good time. We rested. We got 30 minutes left. Relax.
Don't do
go upstairs
it
after this and book some more shows with
it
us.
Relax.
But relax. Don't seriously, do we don't.
You know what? When we looked at each other today and said, can we be really good friends and still fuck each other?
Of course you can.
And we both looked and
you
said, yes, we could do
friends
that. It was like, all right.
Here's are what you happened.
Guys,
you guys,
I mean, where do you want us to go, man? That sounds like happiness.
Wait
to
a minute.
Both
you
of us
guys, listen, you can go on and you can do the friend thing, and that's great. But guess what? Someone's going to get hurt. And someone's going to get hurt hard.
Yeah.
Oh, Pete.
Because you know what? She can be at Frankie's with a emotional friend, or you could be at the mall with an emotional friend.
At Frankie's.
And all of a sudden you see. Well,
Frankie's.
That's the water people
dog
go.
Pete. Is that the fucking hot dog spot?
That's where Waterbury people go. What the fuck's wrong with you, fucking East Haven
I'm
people?
I'm not for fucking. I'm not for.
He's Bridgeport.
Bridgeport.
You know what? We live. We actually live next to the original Frankie.
Thank you.
They live next to the original Frankie's. Right,
Watertown
right in Bunker
Ave
Hill, man. Right up
no
Watertown Ave.
That.
Morningside.
No.
The Morningside Avenue, Waterbury, Connecticut.
We have different beliefs out here. Food is up. We have blackies, dude. Come on.
But I guarantee you, give it time.
Hey,
you're
don't knock our hot dog
it
joints.
Don't knock breakies.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, my aunt and uncle, hey, they met there in like 1936. They were married like 50 fucking years, okay? So
and
fuck
not,
you.
And
I wish that was a real story. I mean, it is a real story.
Really?
Yeah, my uncle Frank Paparazzo, you dumb fuck.
Sorry, I'll stop talking.
Don't make me come over there and start smacking you, all right? All
right, go get your fucking shine box.
Go get your fucking shine box.
All right, listen, let's calm down. I'm not saying this out of selfishness because I don't want to lose you guys. Of course we're not going to do it. I'm serious.
No.
You're going to fucking regret it.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what? If that
you're going to regret it.
Don't even fucking do it.
His hole is
Yeah,
huge.
You're very intuitive.
You're very
don't
intuitive.
Don't do it.
But
listen, do this.
Got some
kind you know what?
Don't do it.
Make believe.
You
know? Hold on. Make believe.
Floating there.
Make believe you're both a drug and take it one day at a time. Don't worry about what's going to happen 2 months from now, 3 months from now. Have fun tonight. Because you know you're going to when you leave here.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Have fun
you
tomorrow.
You guys are in love.
Have
Stay
fun.
In
you
love.
You know what? If you guys worry about what the timeline is before you break up, it's going to ruin what you have now.
You only live once. You get one ticket.
That's true.
Fucking make the fucking ride.
Enjoy each other now because he can die tomorrow. You can die tomorrow.
Before he...
I could die today.
And you can't be thinking 3 years.
Bob,
we need
you.
A two-year break.
Yeah, fuck that.
That shit doesn't work, man. Life throws curveballs.
The only thing that should be 3 inches is the labia, and that's really long. So
that's way
yeah,
too
that's,
long.
But we don't need meat curtains in this.
But okay,
no,
you know
what
we
forgot
to
do?
Those
that
should not be
3 inches.
Camel toe.
So.
You know what we forgot to do? We forgot to have Joe pick a pool date.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's
a dead pool date.
I didn't get a pool
So we're
going
to let Charlie do a song, and we'll get back to you guys. But right.
Thank
think
you.
Out of it. Charlie. Make it a make it romantic, will you? No. I'm
make God bless you
Go, Beans. Give him something to bang it out to.
You got to sit together.
Is this going to be a hate
so
one?
Fucking jealous yeah.
Oh, yes.
I'm sorry.
No way.
You know what, Mike? Yeah. Mike, you know what? There's a caller that wants to say something. Mike, go ahead. You're live.
God, you can be such a douche.
What, sir?
That's my mom.
It's your mom. God, that just fucked us all up, right, Jimmy?
That was perfect.
What'd you walk into, dude?
I don't know. I love it, man. We got a little all music, right. a little therapy, a whole bunch of jokes.
Does anybody have a cassette player?
No, I'm good, dude. I fucking love that you even said that out loud at 25 player? Years old.
I have a tape that I made.
Come
if anybody
on,
wants
you made a cassette?
It.
You
oh,
got a cassette
that's
player.
Fucking amazing.
So the song I'm about to play.
I'm sure
is
Mike does.
The last cool. song on the cassette. It's called Metro.
I'm sure Mike has a fucking.
And it's my. I like
the
song.
That's
to play.
Fucking amazing.
No, it's for you guys. He said, take it.
You hear that?
25 year old kid just gave me a tape. Oh, get sorry. The fuck out of here.
I love it.
That's what he
said.
Take it.
Awesome. Let's go, Beans.
Thank you, Pumpkin.
There is but one way.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Nice.
Nice. That was really nice. Yes.
That was taking back to Pound Town, brother.
That was Stay really
Squamicat.
Still keeps going. I was gonna keep my going, mantra, brother. But he still keeps going. He just won't shut the fuck up. I'm telling Who's you, this? Bob. Don't worry about who it is.
Oh,
you know exactly. He just won't shut the fuck up. He doesn't realize. He does not realize. And I know he's listening with his bottle of champagne right now. You're a narcissistic asshole. And I can't keep my mouth shut all fucking day. But you know what, Mr. Fucking Tough Guy, you and your friends, come take a ride over here.
Smack
okay?
the bitch up.
Because you ain't shit without your fucking pen and
Smack
paper.
Smack the bitch up.
I hope you fucking remember that. Because I'm tired of your fucking bullshit.
Yeah.
Tired of it.
Keep telling people this and that. You make fun of my punctuations and my spelling. You know what? For intelligent people to make fun of someone's disabilities or whatever, you're fucking less than intelligent. You're fucking bitches. So
Relax.
Let's talk street talk now, punk
Relax.
Ass.
Relax. When he gets
no,
fucking
I'm fucking,
bitch slapped,
I'm
bitch
telling
slap.
You.
Don't worry about it.
Wait. He can fucking go fuck himself and stick that
hey,
champagne
hey.
Bottle in his ass.
You ain't got to worry Phil. About nobody.
Are you talking about Phil?
Don't say his name. It's like Voldemort. He who shall not be named
I
ever.
I didn't say anything.
Fuck that no, cunt. No.
I didn't say anything.
The guy's being an asshole. He's an asshole. You call him out for it.
Yep.
When he gets
I'm
fucking
sorry.
Smacked.
I generally...
He'll feel it.
Just shut the fuck up and
right.
move on. It's that simple.
You're the one who wanted out.
Then
go.
The
fuck out.
Then go. Fucking bitch.
He's not worth the
When
time.
He gets fucking slapped, he'll
I
feel
mean,
it.
You know,
and you know what? Peter, you know how I'm beating his ass? Because there's 152 people that weren't listening when he was the fucking producer. So go fuck yourself.
He didn't hit 100.
So you lost, bitch.
Sucking,
he never hit
bitch.
100
exactly.
with him there.
Start sucking.
That's how you. I win because you're a fucking bitch and couldn't produce. It took me 3 days
root,
to get this
bitch.
Many.
Boom.
It took you 3 years to try to get half as many, so fuck you.
Fuck you again.
Bitch.
Call me a fucking drug addict again, and I'll fucking rip your head off.
So how are we doing on that side of the table?
Can I have a PBR? Do you have an extra PBR?
Ooh.
Can you go get two upstairs?
Yes.
Nice. Switching nice. Over.
We want to get back to you two, but Bob's got to
yeah,
sing a song.
Yeah, we can't leave that alone.
No, we need Pop's support. Hey, did you?
What about me?
You're breaking up. Get your own.
Hey, did you see 25-year-old makes a mixtape?
He gave us one.
That's fucking amazing. 25-year-old know what a tape is.
You should come on more often, Jamie. You're so excited.
My nipples are hard.
Oh.
They're useless, but they're hard. See what I did there? That's a comeback.
Right, and you did it against yourself, so there's no being sued. Bam.
Again.
Bam.
Okay, I'm going to cover a song. Get you in trouble.
What's up, brother?
Oh, yeah. There we go.
Okay. So, there is
this
guy.
How many did you get?
Five.
It's almost over.
I said
six. Well, I could take one.
I can't.
Eventually, I'll drink it.
Tomorrow, buy me a two-pack.
I'm
broke. I got money now.
Cheap
so anyway,
fucking motherfucker.
I usually tell a story about how it took 3 years for this guy to write this song. But I'm not going to tell that story tonight. The song became special to
Play
me.
Play that fucking tune, Bob.
Shortly, because of the last line in the chorus where it talks about, I always thought that I'd see you again. And... 2012, I lost my two sons, and they were always supposed to be there.
God bless you, brother.
So this song took on a different meaning to me.
Yeah, I would think so.
Thank you, Charlie.
Big time.
Nice show.
Don't be sorry. Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone.
You too, Bob.
And the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen so many days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you
again. Yes, I always thought that I'd see ya again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me find this hand. Just know when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. That's the wrong line. There's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Oh, yeah. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Yes, I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. Lord, no, no. Never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Yes, I always thought that I'd see you again. Yes, I always thought that I'd see you again.
That's a, you know, that's probably done about twice the tempo that it James did it at. But that's because I look at that song instead of being a sad song as being a song of happiness and survival and getting through it.
Speaking of happiness and survival, how are you guys doing?
Is this something about
was that not the perfect segue song?
Can I say something about that song?
Good.
So my father passed away when I was 15, and I like didn't really know him. I saw him sometimes, but I was listening to that song in my room after it all happened, and my mom came in and she like started crying because I never knew this, but that was like one of the songs that he always played on guitar.
Aww.
And it was just like a weird kind of thing where I was listening to it afterwards. I fucking love that song so much.
I do too.
Nice.
It makes me like tear up when I hear it, to be honest.
I occasionally have trouble getting through it, as you witnessed tonight. Yeah. I could not do that second verse. And Anthony died of a drug overdose. And, that second verse is about him defeating his cocaine habit. So I have trouble getting through that occasionally, and I did tonight. So, hey, that's life.
That was a perfect segue song, too, for you guys.
Yes, let's talk about you guys.
Holy shit, like, oh, wait, that's a perfect song to wrap up, like, therapy
Let's
hour.
Talk about you guys.
what I just heard is a lot heavier than us.
Is it, though?
Yes.
All right,
yes,
let's take a break for 1 second with you guys. Coming up tomorrow night, we have the Podunk Throwbacks, which is a band. They will be here along with Chris Bepko and comedy from me, yeah. Ricky, Casey, and Brian D'Angelo.
You got Chris coming in?
Nice.
Chris Bepko, you know?
Yeah. Is he coming with just himself, or is his drummer coming?
He said himself. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Okay.
This is just remnants. I don't know.
Remnants?
I told him to come.
Yeah, well, you may have a conga player. In
oh,
there,
that's
too.
Right. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. I think he does have a conga player.
And I'm going to tell you something. Those guys will blow you away.
Awesome. So tomorrow's a really good show.
They've been down.
Is Podunk as in Podunk the bluegrass? Are they the bluegrass band?
Yes.
They could be.
Really?
Yeah, they are.
You're not going to have a lot
Podunk
of room in here.
Podunk throwbacks.
No, he said there's only four of them.
Was that tomorrow night?
Yeah, but you also got two.
Yeah, guys. I think Kathy and I need a little therapy tomorrow night.
Oh.
I do too.
I think we got.
You guys
got
to fucking get together.
Just to get over.
You want
to
do a threesome?
Talk about what the fuck's going on.
Just to get over.
Oh, you don't want that creepy old cock in between you two.
Dude, you don't want a guy like me.
Dude, we don't need it. We don't need it.
Mike, honestly, you
can you imagine looking at Bob naked?
Hey.
Not me. I mean, it's like, I'd be like,
hey, I'm in pretty good shape.
He actually is for his age.
Yeah, man. Fucking ain't right.
I can't get over
the
mustache.
You know, he almost looks like a big bowl of rice pudding.
I can't get over the mustache. You got to shave the mustache.
Yeah, you do look like a guy that was on a tricycle.
Yeah, you look like pedophile.
You look like a guy that's on the big wheel.
We don't want pedophiles fucking reminders around here.
I think the mustache is kind of like from
Herbie Hancock?
The commissioner of police in the...
No,
you mean the old Irish cop that used to beat the shit out of the Italians?
Yes. Pay me the fucking $20 or kick his fucking ass.
Mustache reminds me of something you would get.
Look, there's another WAP. Let's kick his ass.
Fabulous.
Kick his ass.
All right, so I want to say thank you for everybody that came tonight. We're definitely going to talk after the show.
I didn't come yet.
Definitely.
Definitely talk after the show and get some more dates.
We may be finished, but I didn't come.
We ain't got to stop.
Motherfucker.
Do we got to stop?
Yeah, I hurt this stuff.
I hurt?
They just stopped us?
No.
I'm just
saying. The episode to go down.
I'm saying. You need a couple of guests. I make a couple of moves on.
We're
the
gonna
street.
Listen. I got my calendar open upstairs. Don't you worry,
I
Jamie.
Bring
too.
In
styles.
Who do you want?
Darling,
bringing the big styles.
Wait a minute. You know, you don't even realize that this is the. We didn't even go out the box today. Right. We proved that we can get ratings with just the PPRN
we don't need
family.
Fucking nobody. Fuck that.
Right?
Families.
Right?
What
I mean,
it matters.
I mean, you don't have anybody.
It literally is the family because he's Saturday. He's Saturday.
Two guys from Saturday. And the rest of us are...
Fuck
are
pedophile,
because
I'll slap him in his puss face. Thank
Come
you.
Come on, let's
relax.
Look,
oh, forget
about
them.
Let's
get
forget about
them. I'm good. I'm on probation. I'm good.
You know.
All right, so yeah, don't forget to tune in tomorrow, and then don't forget coming up Saturday. Hopefully we get some new mixes.
Yeah, DJ M3. You know I got you.
Right.
DJ M3. He's going to probably send me eight this
brother.
Week.
I'll send you.
Yeah,
I know Charlie was on vacation last week. So
that's the benefit to being a stay-at-home dad.
I'll tell you what. Charlie was the most loyal one until you came around.
Always.
Whoa. So now you guys are competing.
I want to get with Charlie and collab. I don't want to.
No. I'm saying like Charlie would be like, boom.
Yeah.
Every Thursday, boom.
That's it, man. I love music.
And then I wrote that one email, and he's like, "Fuck you now. I'll send him what I want now." Prick.
No, that sounds like
I know.
I was in the woods away from everything.
Listen, I get it. It's a lot. Dude, between the fucking five of you guys, I got over...
And we all cover...
I want to say 100 hours of mixing.
And we cover genres, too. So like,
yeah, nobody repeats.
Right.
Nobody repeats.
We got to have...
I love it. I love it.
Tune in, turn it up.
Between the six of you, I got... with you, I have... You caught up. With you, I got 7 or 8. With Charlie, I think I got about 12. So that's 12 hours. That's fucking 8 hours. I got a lot of shit. So
yeah,
Labor Day is going to be kicking.
Labor Day. Labor Day is when you're going to tune in. Tune in, turn it up.
And I don't think I'm going to do blocks like I do now. I'm going to just put shit and Jamie against fucking Manny and Charlie against
just mix it. Throw it together.
Put that shit on fucking shuffle.
I'd probably make your life a lot easier.
Yeah, I probably would.
We need Mike back, though. We got to find out
Listen,
what
man.
Happens.
You know what? Like, if you ever have any, like, dead air, just put on a Disney movie. Or just put on porn.
I can see why
you get
leaving.
Just put on porn. Just put on porn. That's all. Just like just run porn.
We have a friend that paid for porn.
They'll never
be one party one night.
Nobody can see it, right? Right? It's just on the radio, right? So
yeah,
you can run
sound.
It, man.
Yeah.
I mean,
I never
just
let them
like put on some 1972.
As long as it's
70s,
I mix in obscure presidential speeches in a mind.
Hey, can I do the porno show?
That's you.
Can I do the porno show?
Oh my god! I tune in and I catch those, and I was like, what the fuck?
I
want to
do the vintage porno
show. Amazing.
What, his mixes?
Yeah, the first weekend I was on.
If it don't sound normal, it's Charlie.
Well, that's what he said. He said he puts in the presidential speeches.
The first
time I tuned in, I was in my car, and I tone in, and I'm like blasting it in my car. And I'm like, what the fuck? People are looking at me.
I put
love
on
you,
like
bro.
Weird effects on like L.
You're tune in and listen to Beans this weekend, man. He
fucking
kills
right.
it. Kills it.
That's why you guys are on after
Charlie.
Fucking
I
night.
I put a lot of work into it, and Charlie. I feel like it's always just whatever. The
no, usually, it's always awesome.
Wait,
bro.
You want to know the truth?
I'm
good,
out
Charlie.
On a Saturday night at like 11, which is when you're usually at.
Yeah.
So I come home, and I actually go to the podcast.
You go to the massage parlors.
Fast forward.
You know what, though? Everybody, you know, no one's ever bitched. That's one thing I love. No one's ever bitched about their time frame. But I'll tell you what, between when it comes from... The EDM, that's a whole different animal, dude. I pick up 100 listeners just on that. from Charlie's set all the way until 10 in the morning.
I think we should go 6 to 11.
Yeah, I'm telling you, dude. It's nuts. So we have to go. We have to do what we learned, babe. Did you learn anything?
I learned that Joe creeps me out, and I'm a little afraid for your life.
Joe Riley.
That fucking freak.
Joey SVU.
Oh, that Joe. I'm like, whoa,
you mean the caller?
Joe's over there.
The Ricky freak caller? I was a little afraid, too.
I really think Joe's okay. We just have to explain to him how creepy he comes across, and yeah. I think he can learn.
Well, Jamie tried, and he couldn't get it through to him.
No. I think we got through to him. I mean, it's been therapy night.
We'll see you next week.
It's been therapy night.
Joey SVU.
He needs a therapist, definitely.
You know what's scary? Because he knew what my favorite show was.
Yeah, that was scary.
Yeah.
He knew my favorite show, and that's scary. He calls in like
he's just fucking
psycho.
This is like
psycho. His third or fourth time calling in.
And he's really serious too when he talks. Like, all I want to do is have a conversation.
I'll twist his fucking neck.
Dude, I'm on the radio. I don't want to, you know. I don't even want to see you at a park. Have a conversation.
Well, no, you wouldn't see him at a park. That's the problem, Pete. That's
the
what
bushes.
We're talking about.
Yeah. If you saw him, you'd be in trouble.
All right, Charlie, what'd you learn?
I like Casey. I learned that. I liked him probably like as a host over Phil, you know.
Fuck Phil.
Wow, even Charlie.
Easy, Casey.
He's a little aggressive. Casey's
did
aggressive.
I say that
but
loud?
Good. Yeah, you did. That's okay.
Conveyor belt.
That's okay.
Yeah. I agree.
Fuck, I'll slap that
let
bitch.
Go. No,
I liked Bob's rendition of Fire James Rain. Taylor. Yeah, it was cool.
Thank you.
God bless
thank
you.
I love Charlie.
Oh, yeah.
Charlie's
I love,
the best.
I love what Charlie does.
I do,
really,
too.
Really, really do.
All right, we only have 2 fucking minutes left. Let's go. No kidding.
What, are you going to 69 each other?
No,
what?
When Bob goes into his Nixon speeches, we're here for a month.
LBJ.
I really
LBJ
love him.
Jamie, all the way.
Jamie, it's great to meet you. I love your mixes.
So thank you very much.
Yeah. Girl. Am I nuts?
I'm sorry.
Am I nuts?
Oh, well, anyway, I'm not going to go there. That's
go
not.
There,
no,
you already did.
Yeah, I did.
All right.
You did.
Casey.
Fucking love
fun.
You, Bob.
Yeah.
I love his, what he learns. He says your name and then he shakes his head. Everybody knows what he means.
Fuck you. I fucking love you, Bob.
Am I wrong?
What else do I got to say?
I like.
And you go. Tears in his eyes.
Oh. What? Anything else? Huh? Any more nods? No.
I'm glad the girls came.
She's over. She lives there. All the girls.
The girls.
All 8 of them.
No, 4 of them.
2, 4, 5, 6. 6 of them.
6, okay.
2, 4, 6. We appreciate it.
You got to give credit to the ones that actually carry them.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, okay.
So the 6 of them are
the six.
Okay.
The 6 girls are here. Yes.
Ricky wants a fucking operation to make them fucking perkier.
I want a lift.
It's called duct
wants
tape.
A lift.
It's why? Called duct tape.
To what? To prove.
All right.
We'll hold them for you.
Eyes just
oh, no. Wait a minute. That bra, you know what that bra's saying right now? It's like, get the fuck. Let me out of here. Those things are heavy. Those things, like, God.
Nothing wrong with
problems.
A little hang time.
A little? She's got a balcony.
Oh, my God.
I'll give you her back problems. Are
huge.
Sure.
Balcony
you look great.
Straight up.
Thank you.
Of course she looks great.
And that's what she wants to do.
Can't wait to see her in her dress.
Jamie?
Oh, that's going to be one of those moments.
I have pictures.
What'd you
are
you
going
to cry? Oh, fuck. Yeah, I'm a bitch.
Well,
that's
here.
Awesome.
I have no testosterone in me.
I got to tell you.
I yell at people at night and then my friends beat them up.
That's all that counts. I got his fucking back every time. And I always will.
I'm one of them guys.
My sister is very close
don't
to my age.
Don't step to Pete because I'll smack
okay,
you.
I'm not going
to
say how old she is. But she's talking about getting a lift. Okay?
Butt lift?
No.
Titty.
The upper shelf.
Bobies?
The upper shelf.
Do it. Tell her to do it.
Yeah, but at a certain age, it's got to stop.
No, it doesn't.
Why?
No way.
16 and perky?
If it makes you feel
so
good
what?
About yourself.
16 and life just
how old
so
are you?
What if I put how brand new fucking silicones in a 70-year-old and she died a month later?
No.
I don't care.
No.
I don't care.
Not silicones. A lift. They stretch
they,
down.
They.
So what are they going to do, tie strings on her nipples and put it around her neck?
Yeah. Like a reduction.
Exactly.
Not a reduction.
Well, it's
no.
Like, one, right?
Like no. A birthday hat?
it's like skin removal, man.
Yeah, it's like skin. Pinata.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. It's not. It's not.
Okay.
It's not an addition. Okay. She doesn't need that.
Well, she needs a permit needs for
them,
that. Yeah.
She needs them from around your waist up to her chest. You know.
Whatever makes you feel good about yourself.
That's right. Exactly.
It's socks to rocks.
And what's wrong with it?
You feel good about yourself, man.
Right. Do it.
They
nice, James.
It, so.
Socks good to answer. Rocks. Yeah,
yeah. I know. He's
socks to
it,
rocks.
Okay.
Whose turn is it?
Over here.
Jamie.
Jamie, are you done,
Bob? You learned, brother.
I learned that PPRN is where I need to be, and I'm happy to be here. Aww. It's awesome to meet Charlie. Great to finally meet Pete. Nice to meet you, Casey.
You
guys figure your shit out. Ricky, congratulations, and good fucking luck. And I thank you, Bob. I've never been in a song before, and I can't even
you
tell you.
You should have seen his face when you
said that. That was fucking insane.
And Jamie was like, holy
and you pronounced
shit.
My name correctly. You got the pronunciation. That's
so jealous of you. I love your name. Oh,
thank you. I didn't see you. Otherwise,
I love
I never
that name,
there,
Jamie.
So. Tune in on Saturdays.
Bob, seriously, when you were singing, and all of a sudden you went, and I told him today.
Yeah,
friend,
he said he put your
I'm
name
like,
in
you put
song,
your number. He didn't know. And then he's sitting there, all of a sudden he said your name, and he's like,
holy shit, fucking awesome.
It's like someone said, name. Pizza's here. There's pizza upstairs.
All right, get away.
I like to surprise people like that.
I love it.
Mike, the first time I did it.
Charlie, they just want to go home.
You
Bob,
face.
I love you. You're the best.
Okay, good.
Awesome. Thank you for having me. I hope I get to come back.
Yo,
mixtape Saturdays. Tune in. DJ yes, M3. Yes, make sure you check out Charlie Beans.
Yes.
All you fuckers.
Fuck yeah.
That's it.
Kath.
All right. Let's hear it.
You look like you just had sex or something.
Or she's a
you know, two bottles of wine and straight <she's> the PBR. It's the same look.
She's frizzing her hair now.
He's got the cowboy boots.
I don't know what the fuck I'm going to say.
I've learned that.
That dick is good.
That my boyfriend's going to fucking dump me.
Jamie's mad cool.
Thank you.
Very oh, mad cool. Wow.
Mad cool.
Hold
Charlie's
on a second.
Sick on the guitar. I love his whole... thing.
Oh my god, I almost didn't do it. I almost didn't do it. I thought, is this in bad taste? But you know what? I went for it. I went for it, and I am so glad I did. Oh, worth it. Totally worth it.
Totally worth it. Fabulous.
Charlie's like, it's still going?
That was so long.
I've learned of the changes that have happened, and I hope we could all love one another.
I spit in your mouth while you sleep.
One of the main things I've learned is that, Bob, I didn't know that you had lost two sons, and here's to
look.
Your sons, and that was an amazing
thank
rendition
you.
Of Fire and Rain.
Thank you.
You're welcome, thank you.
God bless you, Bob.
And I've learned that I wish I let Mike say the real reason we were breaking up so we could really get in deep.
Oh, we got time.
Next week, stay tuned.
Kind of
next week's
right
episode on The Guiding Light.
Are you going to Chicago?
And I love you, Casey.
Thanks. I'm here to please.
And Pete. And Ricky.
Yeah, I was saying, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Turn the lights off.
I don't want Mike swinging at me.
Can I talk
want Mike
now?
Swinging
well,
at
well,
me.
We're not together no more now.
We're still
let's
together.
Go, Mike. Stop it.
They're going home.
I thought we were going to go all the
all right,
way.
All right. So I got this text. Okay. And it's from my niece in Colorado. And she says,
Santina?
My friend Dan Stack said he used to be on PPRN.
Yeah, he did.
And one time he got a tattoo on the show.
Yep, he did.
Yeah, he did.
He said he did not get along with a guy named Peter.
then he
welcome to
what
my
the
world.
Fuck he's talking
about. None of us do anymore.
And then she says, I've been laughing so much, I've been crying.
Nice.
And that's all we're here for.
That's right.
Absolutely.
You know
that's
what?
Exactly
when it all
it.
Comes down to it, we just want to hold your interest for a couple of minutes.
I
want
actually,
we want to talk like hey, real people.
When is the last time she talked to him? Because me and Dan have spoken in the past 3 months, though.
I don't know.
He said hi to us. No, he was.
Well, she's on it. She's
one of his friends was on the show, and he told him to say hi to us. Remember? Remember he said dancing, whatever. Listen, when two heads go at it, it just doesn't work out. That's all it is. Two competitions, two fucking comedians.
Two similar
comedians.
Heads.
Yeah, there you go.
The bottom line.
I don't wish him any bad. And
I liked your comment, though. Yeah. That's why we're here, right?
Yeah.
Ego. Well, you know, if they'd let me speak again, I thought I had the stage.
Yeah,
right.
I thought it was your.
Can I have center stage, please?
It's your turn now. Go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead.
As they say in the theater,
can I
have center stage, please?
Yeah, go
I
ahead.
Thought we got rid of the narcissist.
Nah, I'm in theater, dude.
Okay,
go ahead, Mike.
I love myself.
You clean the theater.
Thank God. I wish there was mirrors all over the stage.
All right, Farrah Fawcett, let's go.
Okay, no, but anyways. Mary, all I want to say is that it's nice to be able just to talk and talk as people. And hopefully everybody can relate to that.
Yeah.
And
tonight flow.
Tune in
good.
For a little while. That's it. That's all
flow.
I got. What did
good
I learn?
Flow.
What did I learn?
Yes,
like
that's
flow.
That's
give me the fucking check, bitch.
He never shuts up.
Never.
Actually, he's always
Casey.
Been. No, wait.
What I learned is Casey never shuts up.
But that's kind of true tonight.
Actually, that's not true because he hasn't talked until tonight.
That's right.
And he's drank. That's why he drank tonight. So.
That's why he drinks then.
No, he doesn't drink at all.
Oh.
He drank tonight,
it was
and
all
that's
fake
why
alcohol. Yeah. That he just guzzled.
No, this is real booze.
No, we're just kidding. That is. I hate to break
normally
the news, Casey,
Casey's
Bud Light is not real booze.
That's normally right. Casey's on the
PBR.
Panther piss.
Normally Casey's on the social media, being quiet and being good. So. Yeah,
well, he would occasionally
tonight's
come in
treat.
There with a little zinger.
I went back to the old school where we were in Southbury when I
no, I didn't go back there.
Are you guys old friends?
I did.
No fire.
No fireball. All right, what
I
else
didn't
you learn?
Do no shots. I don't need no shots.
I don't need no stinking shots.
I need no stinking shots.
What else you learn? Anything
to use?
I learned that everybody needs a bad guy.
Hey.
Huh?
Say goodnight to the bad guy.
It's going to be a long time before you see a bad guy like this.
Can I take back my last hour of conversation? Okay.
No, that's it. I'm done. I'm done. I'm out. Over.
You guys are
drop
definitely
the mic.
Not out. What fucking
mic.
Pisses me off is because I was fucking trying to incorporate you in and you fucking break up on me. Fuck.
Man, stop it. Stop it. They're not broken.
You're in. You're
yeah,
in.
Yeah, but you're like yes, moving you're to in. Colorado.
I don't fight yet.
Not yet.
Bring, that shit. Bring that shit home. I'm going to fight
and
at the fucking end of the show.
Bring it home and fuck it out and don't even think about it again.
Right.
And that is how you solve relationships problems.
I learned.
You fuck it out.
You know what you do? You fucking hot boxer.
Oh, my God.
There you go.
Hot boxer. That's what you do. And then you just fucking take a fucking big load and throw it right in their face.
We're trying to keep them together, Pete.
You Spider-Man-er.
I can't.
I like
Ricky's
that idea.
Like, I wish you could just pull your penis out at least.
I can't be here.
You're
right
talking
now.
All this shit,
right?
I wish I could
finger.
See your dick at least.
Show your finger and message.
I think.
Oh
Pete
my
has a
god!
Point. I love you guys. You're not going nowhere because I'm gonna fix this.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You guys
yeah,
break it up.
Yeah, we'll
Ricky,
do, we'll
I got
do,
a
we'll
fourth
do,
job.
You'll be
we'll
here.
Do, we will
here
do radio therapy every night.
I like it.
Ricky, just I got a fourth down. Job.
You'll
don't,
be here again.
Don't be Phil.
Oh, my
tell
God.
Me the time.
Fuck Phil.
Don't. Just send Phil love.
No.
Oh, boy. Yeah, all right. Is there anything else?
No, I'm done. Over.
And out.
Kate, oh, here we go. What'd you learn, Casey? Look at Charlie's like, hurry up.
Charlie, I learned that Charlie's gonna fucking hurry to get the fuck out of here.
Call Uber,
and
bitch.
Tune
he's got a promise.
Great.
He's got a
Bob,
promise. What?
I fucking love your music.
Thank you. Thank you.
You guys, I love you two together. Please stay together. Just work it out. You know what I mean?
Whip it out, work it
we
out.
We can work it out.
We can work it out.
What the fuck?
She's got to up sex 5 times.
Ricky. Is ready to step up when needed. I learned that.
Cheers to my bitch.
That's your girl, go.
That's my bitch.
That's your boy, bitch.
Actually, I'm the bitch.
You
that's
are
my,
the
that's
bitch.
My man, right?
That's what I said.
That's my man right there.
And I fucking love being on the show.
Thank you. We love you having you here.
Thank you.
And you have the best burps ever.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. That I was thought, like creepy pickup line.
Yeah, but...
I love the stuff that comes out of your mouth that smells awesome.
Can did you hear
burp
him
in
burp?
My face?
I don't need garlic.
You're just jealous.
Ever.
Did you hear his burp before?
I know he beat me.
Oh, my God.
I
so
beat the fuck out of him with burp.
He beat me this week. He beat me this week. I'll give him this one. Listen, I am not
I'll
one
take
to...
this week.
He had better burps than you this week.
I am
sorry.
Not one to not give credit where credit's due. I'm not that guy.
His and verbal flagellance was amazing.
Yes. His I can't wait till he does it to my forehead.
Fabulous.
He could fart from the mouth like nobody I've ever
right.
seen.
Do me some.
Can you do me a favor and teabag me and burp on my face at the same time?
Oh my
do
God.
Me a favor. If you do move to Colorado,
that's a do.
Call in. regularly.
No, Skyping.
Or Skype.
We're going to give you a computer that's got Skype on it, and you can only call us.
I'll do the Montrose satellite. Yeah. And for Montrose.
No one's even going to know you. If you two break up, just keep Skyping in.
The best thing about it is I can sit there and smoke big bones and be legal. It's like, yeah, Colorado. I'm testing the best quality.
Yeah, well, someone else will.
We can smoke them here and not give a fuck about
them. Miserable.
We can just smoke them here and not give a shit about
Well, it's a misdemeanor now.
We're in our basement. Who's going to tell?
Yeah, up to an ounce in your...
Nobody cares.
All right. So what I learned, that... Charlie, you just... I don't know whether he gets angry or... or if he's happy, and then you ask him, and then he's like, no, I'm good. But then you look at him, and he's like, no, I'm not.
It's obvious like, he has orgasms
I got a fifth
fingers.
Job now. I'm a therapist now. I got to fucking figure shit out. Always awesome to have me in a... I didn't mean to pitch you two together, but you're both equally work hard, and it's.
Oh, I'm glad.
You give me less stress, man. Ricky's like, I know Charlie said, because when I'm like on fucking Friday, I'm like, motherfucker, and Ricky's like, I'm not worried about Charlie.
Stuff. Yeah, you got Charlie stuff. You got Charlie stuff.
So thank you. I love you for that.
Thanks for having
me. Thank you for coming, and we're gonna have some more of this roundtable shit. Bob, what can I say, man? I miss you on Wednesdays.
I do too.
I really miss you on Wednesday.
That's why they've extended the open mic into September and October. But I'm only going to do every other week now. I told them they had to find a second host.
Motherfuckers.
Because I'm going to be on the show.
They took my Bob.
Twice a month.
You took my Bob. I love you, buddy.
I
got
to come back to it. I got to come back to it.
I love you, buddy.
I miss it too much.
You know
I have too much fun.
And tonight was fucking, let me tell you something before I finish what we learned. Tonight. We had 180. I think the record one night was 192. And this just proves that the cancer that got cut out is just, it's been a long time. And I learned that from you guys.
You know,
the cancer that got, and I'm not saying names because I don't want to do that. I want to be a mature person. I want to be that guy.
Let it go.
I like being a mature.
But I like that, I like that people have been waiting by the fucking computer wanting, because there's nobody in here that. Made a difference because there's nobody like a band or anything. This is all normal PPRN people. And I love that people sat there and waited for tonight and can't fucking beat that. Dude.
That's right.
Yeah, man.
You can't fucking beat that.
Yeah, you
dude.
Guys
you
are part of that.
You are. Everybody in this room is part of it. Because on the first hour, let me tell you something. On the first hour, there was four people listening. And I was just telling Ricky, I'm like, fuck. And then all of a sudden, I clicked the button and went up to 40. Went up to 90, and it was, what the fuck? But thank you. Thank you to the listeners for doing that. We got one of our good friends, Jay, who used to listen to all the time, Jay Silfen. He's back. Thank you, Jay.
Jay, thank you.
Yeah. Another loss we had.
Yeah.
Jay.
To the old, so thank you, Jay, for being back. Bob, for listening. I want to thank everybody on the thread. Thank you to Alejandro, who's our biggest fan.
My niece, Santina, you got to thank.
Niece,
she's been on.
I love
Colorado
the niece.
Came through
Thanks
again.
Thanks for bringing up the whole Dan thing. I thought I swept that under the rug 3 years ago. Thanks, Niecy. Thanks, Niecy.
Oh, the Dan thing.
Yeah, never mind.
We're good. But thank you, Bob. I'm glad you're still breathing.
Oh, yeah.
I know.
Now, everybody, rethink your
death pool.
Your death pool date. Rethink your death pool.
You know what?
I'm getting stubborn.
Bob, I think you're going to live forever.
Yeah.
I haven't put one in, man.
Okay.
Me either.
I don't even think
I got you next Thursday.
You lose. You're
done.
You lose.
I hope he never leaves.
Bob ain't going nowhere.
We're going to mic his casket if he leaves.
Bob ain't going nowhere.
That's messed up.
We're going to mic his casket if he leaves.
He's going to live past me.
Mic his casket.
We are. The whole time, the whole casket's going to be like...
Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me.
Dude, somebody just slashed the tire. Did you hear that? Somebody just slashed
he
the tire.
He laughs like that character from Bugs Bunny.
No, he laughs like Augie Doggie laughs.
Yeah, Augie Doggie.
There you go.
Yeah,
let me get through
it.
Wacky races.
Let me get through this thing.
Fucking
sorry.
All right. Jamie.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for making the fucking trip from Manchester.
That's right. No problem, man. I'll do it every time.
Dude, man. Between the little time we've known each other, dude, like you got some really good work ethic, and I love that. Thank you. And tonight, dude, wow, what a great! I can't wait to fucking put your name in the computer upstairs for coming back, dude. I really do. You really did awesome, man.
Stronger, better than ever.
Came in and fucking sat in a room with nobody he knew, and just talk shit and got away with it.
Damn fucking Skippy.
But he's big, too, so that can work.
Who's going to
argue fuck with him, right?
Not that big.
I don't want to rile that beast up.
No. But wow, he just fucking got right in the chair and just fucking melted right in with
him. He is skid.
Funny. Very funny.
Thank you.
Very funny.
Happy to be here. Hope to be back.
Are those tattoos real?
Yes.
What, are you kidding me?
You got a lot of things.
Is what you guys just told us over the air real?
It was a bad joke.
Listen, Kathleen. Sorry, whatever happens, it's just going to happen. I don't even know if that even sounded normal.
No, but that's okay. She's always going to be a part of the
show. Whatever's happening, I could see the pain more in your face.
Right?
That's all I'm going to say.
Right.
But I'm not saying it's not equally pain. I'm thinking he's just hiding it better. I think that both of you need to shut the fuck up and just stay together until it's time to leave.
Yeah.
Fuck that, because there's no one for each other but each other.
Until that glorious trumpet blows.
Stop worrying about when he's leaving and just enjoy when he is here now. Because his leaving is basically, you know what your problem is? His leaving is equal to him dying. And it scares you. And it scares you, too, because you don't want to leave. It
scares me, too.
But you have to because you have an obligation to two people. I dropped my mic. I just made $100 million because I miss Chloe. So no, but seriously, I can see that. One thing I
there you go.
I can't.
Hit that shit.
He can I?
No, but seriously, guys, knock it off. Don't break up until you have to.
Or until you've run your course on this show like everybody else.
And please don't break up over a bottle of fucking wine.
1990.
No.
Wine's just the worst.
We were talking about it even before we had a sip of wine.
Wine's just the worst drink to have. Especially when you did drugs.
Red wine.
You drank a box of wine. You woke up the next day like,
red wine is the demon.
My head's pounding. I don't feel good.
Red wine's the demon. White wine
that
is
sugar
a little
sucks.
And that's what we were having tonight.
All right. Well, if you guys have to, you guys have to. But
you're going to be busy.
Just make sure you go home and get those cowboy boots on. We went from you were getting her home and putting her in cowboy boots to now you guys are breaking up.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can't have that.
I think you guys do this every time you drink together.
Could
right or wrong?
Could be.
Just to make the sex better.
This is the foreplay. This is foreplay.
There you go. Good answer.
Yeah. Angry sex.
Is the
angry
best sex.
No.
Go home and fuck it
sex
out.
I think I might have to agree with that a little bit.
Michael,
that
when
makes
I
it better.
Michael, when fucking I first met you, dude, I didn't know what to fucking think, but.
The first night he was on the show.
The first night he was on the show.
Why?
I knew he was a good dude.
Oh, because God, he was arrogant.
Oh, bullshit.
Yeah. I was like, fuck that.
We talked about weed. We talked
no
about
way, man.
I ended up falling in love with him.
No. He was just him, but it was
just
like,
me.
It was such a refreshing kind of approach.
To you,
to
you weirdo.
Yeah, I am a weirdo. I don't give a fuck.
No.
Probably all weird.
You said that to the other guy, not me. Don't say that to me. You care. You care. Come on. I call you Uncle Bob.
I love being down here.
I
will come down here every night. Just call me, but I don't want to be like too repetitive.
Stop it! And listen,
because
I hate those people.
You come.
I hate those people.
You hate the repetitive people.
No, I hate the people that don't think
they
belong here.
They live in
shut that.
Right next to Tom.
No.
Shushy. If I gotta separate you two to have you both, that's what I'm gonna fucking do. Shush. I love you both. And you guys are ridiculous. Stop fucking
shushy.
Funny. Suck his cock, lick her pussy.
Stay together.
I can't say that. I'm sorry.
You gotta find better.
I can't say lick the pussy.
You gotta earn the right to do that.
Listen.
You gotta earn the right to do that.
I'm
Peter.
The doormat in the winter. I'm frozen, but you can still walk on me. All right, take it easy. Listen, who snorted?
Me.
You better have a 40.
I burped.
Oh, my God.
We're going to talk before you leave. Don't leave abruptly, all right? You guys stop. Here. Stop it.
All right. Hurry up. End the show. I got
to
pee.
Stop it. You go pee. I'm going to need you here. You're not going to be here the week she's here anyway.
I'll be holding her girlfriend's hand in a week.
The new Jamie and Kathleen show.
Casey and Kathy.
Oh, it's the KKK show.
Oh, my God.
I don't have any pock marks.
KKJ show.
I don't have any pock marks.
What did I learn about Casey? Fuck.
Okay, he's putting his bit in.
What I learned? You guys stop it. Stop it.
You have nice laugh lines.
Stop it.
I do.
That'll do.
Easy. I'm going to shut you both up. Shut up. Stop, don't do that shit when he's upstairs.
Oh, knock it
easy.
Off. I would never do it to another.
Didn't you already bang her at the roller rink? Didn't you get through that already?
Like, you're gonna break an elbow.
It's a favorite roller rink. You're 11. What are you gonna do? I'm sorry.
What happened 20 years ago was past the statute of limitations.
That's right.
Okay, I'm done. I'm sorry.
All right, what I learned, Casey, that fucking damn.
God damn. I learned that.
I'm glad you drink once a month.
Yeah. I got to be a social drinker.
Say that again and listen to your
social.
I want you to do me a favor. Tomorrow I want you to rewind an hour into the last of it and listen to it. You're going to be like, oh, damn, I need to stop
drinking. Ricky said it sounded good. That's all that matters. I don't give a fuck.
Love you, bro.
Love you,
too, bro. I'm so proud of your progress and everything that you're doing, and no one understands what you're going through, but.
Staying clean, brother.
That's it, my nivregin.
Step the fuck back, bitches. Yeah.
I want to say thank you for Matt, my friend. Very, very good friend.
Matt Church, good man.
Coming down. This reminds me of the old days.
Yeah.
When Matt would come and we would have a
blast. I think he came because there was somebody who wasn't here.
No, he just. Huh? It's weird that he came because he doesn't know about Phil.
Okay.
He don't know about that shit. He had to drop off his thing because he couldn't afford a stamp. That kid. I love when you come.
Hey, snow is coming.
No, I'm kidding.
I didn't waste a stamp either.
I'm kidding.
Me neither.
It's called a joke.
Bob started laughing, you bitch.
That's called a joke. Too.
But everybody, thank you for tuning in. I just definitely want to give a nice shout out to Ricky for stepping up. And you all at this table don't know what it took for her to sit there and talk. And
I do.
I do.
I don't think anybody does as much as I do. And that's
Ricky. Yes.
Thanks, Ricky.
And when she knew shit was going downhill, she was the first one that said, I know it's going to suck, but I'll do it.
Aww.
That's her voice.
That's ride or die.
That's her voice when she's happy. Yeah. I know it's going to suck, but I'll do it. And then she threw that joke in today, and I'm like, there's my baby.
Right?
Yeah. There's my baby.
Dude, an instant mess. She fucking buried you today.
That's the Ricky I
he
want everybody
you the
to know.
Fuck out. Devo, you got knocked out.
Did you see those little pictures?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
She got you. You already did.
That's my girl, Ricky.
That's right. Next week, we're back on next week. Trust me. I got a new calendar.
Charlie, your tune sounded fucking awesome.
But no, I fucking hit goals with
yes.
this one.
Yeah,
I've been with some people, and I swear to God.
There's some sick-ass bitches out there.
I hit goal with you. And
yeah, you did.
I like that she maintains a little mystery.
Who, yes. Ricky?
Yeah.
No, she's not.
Totally. Are
not
you
at
kidding
all.
Me?
Not at all. That's her. She's got no mystery. That's the problem. She's got no demons. She's never had a drug in her body.
What are you trying
she's
to
say? She's got no mystery. Serious.
What are you trying
she
to
has say? Nothing.
You got to have the yang to your yin.
Wait a
she
second.
She has something.
Wait a second. Nothing. She has you.
Well, she might have sucked mystery. Cock really good back in the day, but that's
oh my
about
God.
It. That's the only secret she's got.
Only back in the day?
No, now.
Only?
Oh. Probably more than you do now. I'm just saying. Well, that's my fault. That's my fault.
That's her. Yeah.
That's my fault. Yeah. Not her fault, but hey. I'm saying she's
that's
got.
That's a leakage.
Everybody sucked cock. Hey, I mean.
Oh, really?
Who hasn't? God damn it.
Pizza. Dick.
You have to.
Penis theme.
Especially if you want to raise.
There was that time.
That's right.
There was that time.
Remember that time in Park Place?
Wow.
There was that time at the toll plaza when I had 17 axles on my trailer.
It's like, yo, man, I haven't got any change. I'm just coming back from Atlantic City. And yeah.
Listen, I can't pay the toll. Can I blow you? No, do you mind? Can I blow you? Just to pay the toll.
All right. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. Don't forget tomorrow night. We're back live. I appreciate it. Don't forget, everybody, to listen to 24/7. And thank you, Bob, for coming. We'll see you next week. Thank
love
you, everybody,
Bob.
PPRN. Thank you, everybody, all the old people that came back. Thank you, Jay. Thank you, everybody. And
Charlie.
Ricky, I love you very much. And we got 52 days left. Yay.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah.
Woo!
Hey, what a party.
I haven't decided if I'm broadcasting it or not.
Start buying stag tickets, you motherfuckers.
I think broadcasting my wedding would be a little
tacky.
Yeah,
but it's who you are.
But we should broadcast the stag.
But it is who you are. It is who you
no.
are.
No. Ricky's like, Peter? Yeah, broadcast the stag. Please.
I don't care.
It is who you are.
As long as we make money, we'll broadcast the stag.
Yeah.
There's no strippers allowed in my stag.
Not by my... I didn't say that. Let's just say
no, she didn't. All right, everybody, as we say at the memory show, everybody, stay black, y'all, and good night. We'll see
stay
you guys
back, y'all.
Night.
Peace. Right on.